We thank you.
Bless the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. I give him thanks. I give him praise. I give him glory. I give him honor for his goodness and his mercy. For his loving kindness towards us and his truth that endureth throughout all generation. You know, people of God, my God Almighty, time past gone. When the Lord God Almighty has given to me a message. And the topic of the message that the Holy Ghost have me to, my God Almighty, to name that message was, what if Jesus, what if God was man? To say, if God was man, what would we do? What would happen to us?
Oh my God.
But really and truly, I rise up to say, my God Almighty, I bless the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And I really and truly thank him to know that my God Almighty cares so much for each and every one.
Thank you, Jesus.
Because, my God Almighty, if we, my God Almighty, really take note of what is going on in our life today, the enemy, my God Almighty, wants for God's people to remain weak, to remain, my God Almighty, as if there's not a God. One for God's people, not to able to look to him, but to look to what he, the devil, is doing.
My God.
That is what the enemy wants. What is for us, people of God, to lift up the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and to put our trust in him. God has given you something, you have to hold on to it strong. Don't let go.
Thank you, Lord. Hold on and do not let go.
Amen. I get to understand, my God Almighty, that the devil is not intelligent.
Right.
Only come with tricks. That's what he come with.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen.
He only come with tricks. He just want to trick your mind.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Have to, my God Almighty, get to a place in the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Because what happened, people of God, especially in such a time like this, we're in the year of 2015, my God Almighty.
Amen.
And I, my God Almighty, would check, my God, at our age here. I'm talking every adult. If we, my God Almighty, could only check our age and look back, my God Almighty, as young people. Look back as teenager. Look back, my God Almighty, as little toddler, infant, name it. You would see, my God Almighty, that we are living in a very dangerous time now.
Hallelujah. Yes, God.
And the enemy, my God Almighty, he want to, my God Almighty, play a trick.
Yes.
Especially on the young people.
Mm-hmm. That's true, amen.
But we, my God Almighty, as children of the Most High God, I'm here today, my God Almighty, to advise the elderly, the middle age, the ones, my God Almighty, that know that they are strong in God. And know, my God Almighty, that there are a lot of elderly that are weak. I'm not asking any question.
Hallelujah.
Because you have many, my God Almighty, in the body of Christ, especially the many that they call mothers in the church. They only pray when they come in the sanctuary. Come on, talk to me.
Amen.
It's not all of them. You have some that will pray. But I rise up to say, people of God, the enemy, my God Almighty, have a way to put the spirit of oppression and depression upon them.
Amen.
My God Almighty, to stand weak. The enemy, my God Almighty, want to put that miserable spirit that is called worry upon them.
Yes.
cause them, my God Almighty, not to be mindful of the God they are serving, but to worry themselves over every little thing.
Yes.
Enemy wants for them to be miserable, my God Almighty, and not to able, my God, to stand on the word of God, to know that, my God Almighty, as long as God is in the midst, it is not for anyone to worry or to fret. Because what happened right here, worry is from the pit of hell.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Such a great blockage in the body of Christ. It becomes where, my God Almighty, people, my God Almighty, not able to pray. Come on, talk to me.
Yes, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes. The enemy wants, my God Almighty, for God's people to keep their focus upon things that is happening in the midst. But I rise up to say, this is for, my God Almighty, us eyes. This is for everyone eyes to be on the Lord Jesus Christ. Just as all the song said, for his eyes is on the sparrow and he watches over us. If God's eyes can be on the sparrow and we are his children, our eyes must be on him. Come on, talk to me.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Eyes must be on the Lord Jesus Christ, because it is time for God's people to stand strong in the Lord Jesus Christ. But the reason why many can't be strong is because, my God Almighty, many are so, my God, caught up in the things of the world. Come on, talk to me. Many are so concerned with what is going on. But I rise up to say, people of God, if I did not choose, my God Almighty, the life that God called for me to live, I know I would be weak as well. But I know I'm not weak.
Thank you, Jesus.
I said I am
Amen.
Not weak,
Thank
people
you, Jesus.
Of God. The Bible tells us, my God Almighty, where Jesus Christ was there, and they come and they ask him, they said to him, they said to Jesus, Jesus, do you think that everyone should pay tax, name it and whatever you, and he said, yes. He said, what give to Caesar what is to Caesar, and unto God to God.
Hallelujah.
I am, my God Almighty, I am speaking what is right in the sight of God. I am not weak. God made me strong. And because he made me strong, I want to encourage somebody, my God Almighty, the third time, to tell you, my God Almighty, that, my God Almighty, there's only one way to stay strong. One way. Only one way to stay strong and to be is to be obedient to the Spirit of God.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
If you are not under the command of God, you will not stand strong. You will not be strong. There will be a waving. This moment you will be feel strong. Next moment you feel as if you don't want to do nothing where God is concerned. Come on, talk to me.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah.
If you notice, my God Almighty, even when it come on, my God, we have in prayer in the morning. And if you notice, my God Almighty, sometimes, my God Almighty, people will push out to come on the line to pray. And next time, my God, even if you call them, they ignore the phone. Come on, talk to me.
Amen. Hallelujah.
They ignore the phone because people of a way, my God Almighty, I'm saying, oh, I have to get up early in the morning. I have to go somewhere so I can't get up to join the line. And still yet, the enemy will keep them busy, not able to pray. Come on, talk to me. But I rise up to say, people of God, it is time, my God Almighty, for God's people to be strong.
Jesus,
the only way you can keep strong, remember what the word of God said. He said, my God Almighty, to each and every one of us as children of God, he said we must pray without ceasing. Come on, people. Don't stop.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. God.
He said we are not to stop.
Mighty God.
I said, he said, we are not to stop. I rise up to tell the people of God, when I just got saved, out, Lord Jesus Christ. I remember, my God, in the year 2013, in the year 2003, when, my God Almighty, I just got saved. And people of God, I was so happy. I was so overwhelmed. I was so overjoyed. I was so happy for Jesus. Come on, talk to me, people, God, people of God.
Hallelujah.
Yes. I was so happy that Jesus get me. Come on, people.
Thank you, Jesus.
I was very happy that Jesus get me. And because I was so happy that Jesus get me, I find myself, my God Almighty, to a place where, my God Almighty, I wanted people of God to have somebody, my God Almighty, as a company to pray with. Come on, talk to me.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
That was, people of God, this is no joke thing. Prayer was the first thing that popped up in my spirit that very evening, even while the Spirit of God was still doing the cleaning and the cleansing on me. Because, people of God, when I remember the stronghold that the enemy have upon my family, he have poverty upon my family, he have, my God Almighty, many living, my God Almighty, in malice, many, my God Almighty, having hypocrisy, many having envy, strife, jealousy, name it. All kind of spirit that you can ever imagine, I think. The enemy, my God Almighty, want to take down the family with. And people of God, when I see, my God Almighty, the Spirit of God come in on me, knowing that it wasn't something that planned, that very evening, in the midst, my God Almighty, of the Spirit of God upon me, I take up the phone when I get a little chance to speak. Because what you all need to understand, I could not speak to nobody for, my God Almighty, a couple of hours well, because the Holy Spirit was doing some cleansing. Come on, talk to me.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen.
I could not speak to nobody. And I rise up, my God Almighty. And when I get up, my God Almighty, that day, that evening, I took up the telephone and I dial, my God Almighty, somebody very close to me, my God Almighty. And I said, you know, I was, people of God, the Spirit of the Lord was upon me. And we all know we cannot pretend the Spirit of God. Come on, talk to me. I'm sorry for the pretending.
Hallelujah. Amen.
I'm very sorry for the many. And my God, my, listen, you have some people, you will call them, and they will be like, they just finished, my God, my cursing. They just finished carrying on. They just finished doing what they're doing. But when the phone rings, my God Almighty, this is them. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. What's up, my sister?
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
How you doing, my sister? This is how they will pretend.
Nice again.
When I rise up to tell the people of God, this wasn't no pretending. The Spirit of the Lord, my God Almighty, was upon me that day.
Yes, thank you.
Because he had me no words. And I remember, my God Almighty, I took the phone up. And when I called, my God Almighty, that person, I said to the person, oh my God, hallelujah, I was like, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. And the person was wondering why I'm saying, because the person was so tense on the other side. The person was so quiet. I said, are you there? And the other person said, yes, I'm here. And I said to the person, well, you know, hallelujah, I just give my life to the Lord. I just surrender to him. And you know, with all the family, you know, we can come together and pray every day and chase the enemy away from the family. Come on, people. That was what came out of my mouth. Don't ask me, people of God, how it happened. Because I know, my God Almighty, that was, my God Almighty, the first, my God Almighty, gift that God has birthed out of my spirit. Prayer. Come on, talk to me.
Amen. Prayer. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
I said prayer.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Because many need to understand, it's only prayer, my God Almighty. And my God Almighty, stand before God, reading the word and doing what you are doing. People of God, let me say this to you. The reading the word is very powerful.
See? Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Worshiping God is very powerful. Name it, people of God.
Amen.
When I rise up to tell you, my God Almighty, doing all of that, my God, prayer has to be in the midst to mix up everything. Come on, talk to the Holy
Ghost.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It doesn't matter, my God, rise up to tell the people of God the greatest thing that can mix in everything as an ingredient for you to stand strong is prayer in the midst of everything.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Amen.
And that is what the enemy don't want.
Yeah.
No one can for God's people to stand strong. You don't.
Amen.
Said he don't want for God's people to stand strong. You don't.
Amen.
What is doing, my God Almighty? What the King is doing? He's putting upon God's people to be so busy, Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes. Amen.
He wants for God's people to be busy.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
He wants for God's people to be busy because what happened? When you're busy with what you're doing, your spiritual life will be so weak. Weak.
Amen.
And not able to be strong.
Amen.
Your spiritual life will be so weak. You will not able, my God Almighty, to give him the praise, the glory, and the honor that he is to get.
Amen.
You notice, my God Almighty, a person that don't have a prayer life, don't care what they do, my God Almighty, they are weak in whatever they are doing. Come on, talk to me.
Amen.
Amen.
Even, my God Almighty, if you're living the word, come on, talk to me. Even if you read the word of God, you have to have a prayer life.
Amen.
Time, my God Almighty, it takes sometimes that you have to, my God, do a prayer and fasting. Come on, talk to me.
Yeah, thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Yes.
Hallelujah. Yes.
You can't, my God Almighty, be for you, my God Almighty, to say you're okay. I'm gonna talk with Jesus. And you said you're talking with Jesus, and your mind is not there because there's so much things on your mind. So much things on your mind. You can't able to focus.
Amen.
You can't able, my God Almighty, to think. Listen to me.
Amen.
What do you think happened there in the midst? You will think, my God Almighty, about every other natural things. But where the spiritual is concerned, you'll be so weak to that. Very weak. Very weak.
Amen.
Very weak to that. Not knowing, my God Almighty, that these are the things that the enemy is doing, bringing a blockage in the midst. I rise up to tell the people of God, when, my God Almighty, I ask the Lord, that day when I stand up to speak with a person, 2003, the Spirit of the Lord came upon me 5 o'clock that evening. And it was about, my God Almighty, after 8. Because I believe it's about in 3 hours straight, the Holy Spirit of God upon me doing some things.
Amen.
When I finished, I was so weak. I was down and out as if somebody beat me. But it was.
Amen. Hallelujah.
The Holy Spirit of God, the blood and the water, was doing some cleansing, some washing, some cleaning.
Thank you, Jesus.
And because it was spiritual people of God, there wasn't much understanding in the midst. I just have to, my God Almighty, what? Surrender myself to him and let him do what he came to do.
Amen. Hallelujah, Jesus.
My God Almighty, when I called, my God Almighty, the young miss, and I said to the person, we can come together and pray for a family. So that, my God, my family can come, able to come together. For every generational curse to be defeated, cramp and paralyzed. This is the person to me. Well, I don't know about that. You say, but I don't know about that. I have to see that for myself. I'm very sorry. I don't know if I can do that. And people of God, when I get off the phone, I just go right down on my knees. And when I went down on my knees, I was crying like, I wasn't crying, I was hollering. come on, talk to me. I was crying.
Jesus.
Because, people of God, I believe, Michael Almighty, such a request should be answered. Because the word of God said, when somebody come into the body of Christ, when a soul has been captured by the Spirit of God, angels in heaven are rejoicing. And when you can have somebody that is serving God way long before you, is going to tell you, I don't know if it's true you're talking. I have to see that for yourself. Can you imagine knowing Michael Almighty that I'm a person that used to Michael Almighty curse bad words? Carry on. Never you hear me talk a conversation about Jesus. And if I call your phone and said to you, and you hear me saying hallelujah, you see what happened, what you need to get and understand. When somebody's spirit is weak and is not strong, they can't able to tap in into the things of God. Come on, people. That's what was going on. The person's spirit, Michael Almighty, was weak when I was talking to the person. So the person could not able to discern what God was doing in my life. You need to understand. I did not, people of God, I did not even think a minute to have the person. Oh, believe me, I did not. Thank you, Jesus. That was something I didn't have to repent about. I'm not lying. Because, people of God, all in my desire was to make it right with everybody. Come on, talk to me. Something, my God Almighty, has happened to me that I never experienced yet in my life, and it was feeling real good.
Amen.
My God Almighty. All I wanted to do, people of God, is to just pray. Come on, talk to me. Pray.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, amen.
I did not even, Michael Almighty said, we can get into the word. I thought of prayer first. Come on, talk to me.
Amen.
But thank God for Jesus. I never forget, people of God. My mother taught us to read the Bible. And I remember when I came, my God Almighty, to New York City. The first thing I remember, I pick up a Psalms book. Come on, talk to me.
Hallelujah. Amen, Jesus.
And it happened, my God Almighty, that I have a Bible. And in the midst of everything, people of God, I sit down, my God Almighty, and I said to the Holy Spirit of God, I said, God, I cannot read this book, or am I going to shall feel the Holy Ghost, Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
I said, God, I cannot read this book. I cannot call every word in it. I know and, come on people, I know the word A-N-D, I know T-H-E, I know I-T, I know I-F, I know D-O, I know H-E-L-P, I know a few words, people of God, but when it come on, my God Almighty, to even the word that said anointed, even my God Almighty say authority, even people of God, name it, dominion, name it, you all know the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, reading the word, my God, I tell you, people of God, when I touch my God Almighty into Genesis, even my God into the Psalms, name it, people of God, I could hardly pronounce the word. I could hardly.
Yes.
I said, God, you see, I am telling this testimony right at this moment to let many, those on Facebook, those on YouTube, all of you on the empowerment line that have family members, close friends, neighbors, stranger, name it, is to let people know, my God Almighty, that Jesus Christ, my God, when he was on the face of the earth, he said, when I go up, I will send, a comforter. Come on,
talk. A comforter.
I will
always send the comforter. In Jesus' name, hallelujah.
I never know, my God, that the comforter, people of God, I never even have the knowledge to know that. All this zeal, that was my God Almighty that came to my spirit, because I rise up to tell the people of God, and this is no anti-pumpkin tin, this is no joke tin, and the zeal that my God Almighty, the Holy Ghost, has put upon me, I'm still carrying it and I give him praise and glory.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah.
I never leave my zeal. Never. I never throw away my zeal. Never, never, never. Because you know what happened? I remember loving music, people of God. Love to be out there to sing, to be on the stage show, dress up, looking real sexy. Come on, let's talk about it. Looking real pretty. Name it on one of you. And that is something that I have such a strong zeal for. Come on, talk to me. About my God Almighty having strong zeal. When you're talking about stronghold, that those things have did add. It did add a stronghold upon my life. But today it is no more. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Today it is no more. Because I rise up to tell you, from before I get saved, I realized God was what? Trimming me down with a lot of things. And I could not understand. But I was just going by the flow. Because I rise up to tell you, when the Lord God Almighty wants to bring you out to make you strong in him, he, people of God, he's going to put his mighty hands. And I'm telling you, when the hands of God is up on your life, don't care what you do or what you say, you have to, my God Almighty, be under his obedient.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
It is a must.
Thank you, Lord. Yes, hallelujah. Thank
you. I say it is a must.
Jesus. Yes, it's a must.
It is a must. And I rise up to tell you, my God Almighty, I never forget, people of God, how strong those things was on my life. But when Jesus Christ come in and my God Almighty start to spin my life around, you need to understand. I only started, my God Almighty, to, I don't know if you all, look, you could understand it if I speak it. You ever know of your spirit yearning for something?
Yes.
Do you ever have a spirit yearning for something? Yearning. I mean,
yes, yearning, yes.
Your spirit yearning so yearning, much for something. Yearning.
Yearning for something.
Yes.
Yearning.
Your spirit yearning, and you cannot help it. And all, my God Almighty, your desire is just on what your spirit yearning for. Thank you, Lord.
Yes. Yes. Amen. Yes.
All my spirit, my God Almighty, just getting yearning for is to, my God Almighty, know the word of God and to pray. Come on, people.
Amen.
Want to know the word of God and how to pray. I did not worry myself how to pray. I did not ask the Lord. I never said to the Lord, Lord, can you teach me how to pray like Philip? I never do that. All I ask him, my God Almighty, to help me with is to read the word. Come on, talk to me. And that's what we all need to understand. When the word of God Almighty is not in somebody's spirit, then my God will stand stagnant and not able to rise to get strong. Come on, talk to me.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen.
So right there, my God, you see, I'm telling my testimony because step by step, these are the things that makes me strong. And I know that somebody, my God Almighty, might not be on the line, might not be on Facebook, might not be on YouTube, but my God Almighty, somewhere, somehow, somebody will be able to tune in and will hear my God Almighty about this message and will know that, oh, that's the same thing is going on in my life. To tell them to hold on strong and don't let go. Hold on strong and don't let go. My God Almighty. I remember, my God Almighty, there was a brother that used to, my God Almighty, come by, because we used to have the church ministry, the house ministry. And people of God, I never forget that brother, my God Almighty. I rise up to tell you, people of God, that my God Almighty, this woman of God Almighty speaking and telling, this is how my God Almighty start to happen. Come on, talk to me.
Amen.
I sit down, my God Almighty. I did not know to say Holy Spirit, but I know to call the name that is above all name.
Amen.
Because I did not have a pastor. I did not have nobody to, my God Almighty, minister anything to me. All I do, people of God, I sit down in the house daily, day upon day, and I call upon Jesus. I desire, my God Almighty, to come out the house and to go somewhere. But I realize what God was doing to my life. You know what he was doing? Every time I put on my clothes to go through the door, he put a weight upon me, and I lay back feeling, and I start to feeling spiritually sick. I thought I was feeling physically sick, but it wasn't no physical thing, it was a spiritual thing. I find myself, my God Almighty, to, my God, go back and change off my clothes and get, my God, comfortable. And my God Almighty, all I could hear, the Bible, prayer. People of God, I did not know to pray, but I open up my mouth and the Holy Ghost just say, come on, talk to me.
Amen.
My God Almighty, I sit there, my God Almighty, and I take up the Bible. I remember this brother, my God Almighty, would come by. He was very educated. And I said to him, I said, you were supposed to know the Bible inside out. He said, not really, but I know as much. I said, well, I don't know much, and I just know the Our Father prayer. And you know, we learn those things from school. I know, people of God, the 23rd Psalms, I could know a little of Psalms 91. Name it. Just mostly Psalms.
Yes.
And I remember, my God Almighty, I was there one day and I sit down and tears was running down. I said, God, look at me. I did not take in school. I did not put out interest for school. I know I need education. Come on, people. This is how I'm talking to God, not knowing, my God Almighty, that education has nothing to do with the work of God. Come on, talk to me.
Amen.
And I sit there, my God Almighty, and I said to him, Lord, you have to teach me. People of God, I don't know what lifts me up, but I just get this strength to sit up, and I sit down in that word. And I remember, my God Almighty, the very first scripture, this is no joke thing, the very first scripture I opened up the Bible to was Ephesians 5. Come on, people. Scripture, the Holy Ghost take me in. Ephesians 5, the Holy Spirit find and give to me. And people of God Almighty, when I sit down there, I could hardly, my God Almighty, call the words, them only one or two. So I was playing ascotch reading. Anybody know about the ascotch playing? I was playing ascotch reading. That means I was reading, and I jump over this word, and I call this one, and I jump over this one, and I call this one, and I jump over this one, and I call this one, and I hear the Lord God Almighty said to me. One day I said to him, I said, God, what is going to become of me? How am I gonna able to call your word. I said, God, let me ask you something. Jesus, why you put so many big words in your... I said to him, why you put so many big words in your Bible? And this is him to me. Every word is important. That's what I hear pop up in my spirit. Every word is important. I said, oh yes. And I said, yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
But I said, God, even though every word is important, I cannot call them. You have to teach me them. And I hear the Lord God Almighty said, just get yourself together and sit down and I will teach you. Lord Jesus Christ, this is something else. I sat down, my God Almighty. Never know people of God how to go about doing it. But this is me. Lord, I am ready, Jesus. Come and teach me. I am ready, Jesus. Come and teach me. Come and teach me. People of God, I never forget. When I see the word, my God Almighty, and I said, my God Almighty, in Ephesians 5. I know the word be. I said, be. E. I could not even pronounce Y-E to know that it said E. Come on, people.
Yeah.
I pronounce it as H-E. Come on, talk to me. And one thing I know with God, He will not rush your people of God. He's a God of patience.
Amen.
Oh God Almighty, what a God, what a God, what a God. And I remember, people of God, I remember when I sit there, I hear the Holy Spirit said to me, remember the word syllable. Just like that, syllable. And I said, yes. I remember I used to get syllable in school. And what is like the Lord, the Holy Spirit teaching so. Let me tell you something, people of God. If you think that the Holy Spirit cannot teach you like you're in school, you make a sad mistake.
Amen.
And I started to break up the word. And I see, be ye therefore. And I was like, far. And I spell far, low, rare. Lord Jesus Christ, come on, people. And I deal with the word, people of God. And people of God, this is no joke thing. In less than a month, my God Almighty, I could read every word. Come on, give him glory now.
Glory to God. Glory be to God. Hallelujah.
Robust, not tired. Because what you all need to get and understand, daily I sit before God. He looked at me and he said to me, you must not go outside. I want you to stay away from people. I said, yes, Lord. He said to me, I don't want you to call no family members. I said, yes, Lord. He said to me,
yes, Jesus.
I want you all for myself. I said, yes, Lord. He said to me, teach your daughter. It doesn't matter how young she is. She's very intelligent. Teach her how to, my God Almighty, go to the bank. Not to the bank. To the bank at the machine. Come on, talk to me.
Yes,
the machine, how to draw money. Tell her, just send her. People of God, I take her, my God Almighty, one day outside because he allowed me to do so. And I bring her to the machine. And I have her dear. And I show her and I tell her. I let her take out money and I... Because at that time I have a little money in the bank. But didn't have much. Because all my thousands that I used to have... What do you think he do with it? He let people take some and he also have me to give it away. So he stripped me completely of nothing. But the little money that come in the bank is a few people, my God Almighty, that he put in the midst of me. Before he put those people in the midst of me, I was only end up people of, and I only end up with one or two people that I started, my God Almighty, in my very, very young stage praying with. And people of God, I take her to the bank and I show her what to do at the machine. I take her to the fish market and I show her how to buy fish. Come on, talk to me.
Amen.
I take her to the meat market and I show her when she buy meat, how to buy it. I show her what things that we would want. I show her how to pick and choose and buy. And from that day, at the age, my God Almighty, of, I believe she was 11. Let me get it right. Yes? She was 11. And check with me, people of God, she's 23 this year. And I'm in my 12 years. Right there, my God Almighty, she was 11. And from I show my daughter all these things, I was able to send her to the store. I was able to send her to the bank whenever a little money comes. She go there and she do exactly what I tell her to do. She buy exactly what I tell her to buy. Even her very friends were looking at her and telling her teacher, they have never seen anything like this. Miss, she know how to go to the bank. She know how to buy fish. She know how to buy this. She know how to buy that. And I tell you, people of God, it was some talking with she and her friends. That's even her friends them come to see me because they were wondering what kind of woman I am that cannot go to the store myself. My God Almighty. And people of God, I always to stay in that house. And on my own with the Holy Spirit of God, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit, the blood and the water, in the midst, people of God, you all need to get and understand. He wasn't, my God Almighty, visiting me. Come on, talk to me. They wasn't visiting me. They live with me. And that's the thing about us. Come on, talk to me.
Amen.
At that time, I tell you, people of God, because you need to understand, I have been boxed in. I have been covered in. I have been covered in. I remember, my God Almighty, one day, while I was there, my God Almighty, I hear a appalling going on outside. So I step, my God, in the living room, going to the window, and I hear the Spirit of God said, shut it, Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Because he said he wanted me all for himself.
Amen.
And my God Almighty, I shut the window and I start to say, Father, forgive me, Father. Because people of God, I hear the voice of God so clearly. Oh my God Almighty. I wish this for everyone in the body of Christ. I wish it for them. Every one of you on this line. Everyone that tune in on YouTube. Everyone that tune in on Facebook. I wish these things for your heart. And my God Almighty, people of God, day in and day out. And it wasn't until my God Almighty when he called me and tell my God Almighty a sister to tell me to pray for her. I was like asking God if he mad. As I said before, he showed me husband. He should bring a man into a dream, and he showed me this man come and take me out for dinner. And I was there, people of God, acting so shy as if I've never been around a man. That's how I was acting in the dream. And people of God, when I wake up, I said, God, you're mad? This is what I asked my father. I say, you're mad?
Yes.
How could you bring man showing me that you know, you have man for me? He said to me, my daughter, I am not giving you any man right now. I'm showing you that there's a man for you and there's nothing for you to worry about. Don't focus on that. I said, yes, Lord. And people of God, it goes on and on. But in the midst of me, Michael Almighty, into that house, that very place where he come in, you need to understand, people of God, it was the worst basement on that street. And I remember, Michael Almighty, for instance, this year, I went there and I asked to get it. The man turned me down. Did you know that in my sinful state, the Holy Spirit sent me back to ask for the same place? After me going around and searching for place, moving from here, moving from there, he said to me, go back to that basement place and find out about the landlord. And there was the neighbor beside me, and I asked them about him. And they are the one that give me the number. And when they give me the number, my God Almighty, the man come by, and he said he will take a month rent and a month security from me. And people at that time, knowing that everybody paying 2 months security, I was only to pay 1 month and 1 month rent and 1 month security. And my God Almighty, people of God, I'm in that house, people of God, doing prayer and fasting like never before. I used to sell out on the street side, and he stopped me. He do everything to block me. I told you all about the police, my God Almighty, that he allowed them to call on me just to stop me from doing that.
Amen.
And people of God, I remember my God Almighty staying in that place. And that is where I would be praying. In the midst of me praying there and doing my little food selling in the house. Stop going out on the street side. But stay in the house doing a little selling, cooking a little food. And people coming by because so many people know about my cooking. But the few that left back decide to buy from me. One day I got up, people of God, and when I look, my God Almighty, into that yard at the front, knowing that I'm a clean person, this is no bragging and boasting. And when I look, people of God, I saw fly as if I never see fly like this before. Come on, talk to me.
Amen, yes.
So many fly, my God, swarm the front part of the house. And where they lodge right at the door, just spinning around in circle. When I see, I said, oh my God, what is this? And people have got to back in the house. And my God Almighty, I remember, my God, I get some lime water. God, that's what we used to back home, my God Almighty. And I get the lime water and I start with that because I said, maybe it's raw, maybe the place is smelling bad or something, but I'm not smelling anything. But I'm saying, what could my God Almighty cause this fly to be in my yard like that? Knowing, people of God, you know, if people come to buy the food and they see the fly, they will turn back. Come on, talk to me. I started shouting out to God and said, God, what is this? And people of God, believe me, my God Almighty, what I did. I never do anything more than start to plead the blood of Jesus Christ and flash the water. Just flashing the water. The blood of Jesus Christ. 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 And I remember, my God Almighty, I start to utter, my God Almighty, the scripture. Come on, talk to me. Whatever signs I know, whatever word I know for God, I start to utter it and say, the blood of Jesus Christ. The blood of Jesus Christ. And when I look, people of God, this is no joke. Every fly scatter in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
But I notice, my God Almighty, the few customers that I have, they just go down one by one, hardly coming. When I started cooking smaller pot, then, my God Almighty, I realized nothing is going on. And people of God, I decided, my God Almighty, to take the cart and to go out on the road, knowing that, my God Almighty, I'm giving my heart to Jesus Christ. And he's telling me something, because what we all need to get, many times God is speaking to us, but we are not listening. We used to, this used to thing, always be a blockage. Come on, talk to me.
Amen, yes.
I want to do my my own thing. I get me the cart, and I get my little stuff then that I would put in the cart, not like before, and I push my cart around the studio. And I would be there, my God Almighty, and everybody got to see mommy. They call me mommy. Oh, mommy, what's up? We haven't seen her for so long. I said, well, you know, I was just spending some time with my Lord, and name it and one of you. And people of God, when I go out there, I remember, my God Almighty, I go out the first night, I sell off everything. I go back and I buy. I go back again for that week, I start to make money. And people of God, knowing that I was selling more than that before, because this I'm talking about was since I got saved, I start to run back out there to do selling. Because before that, people of God, this is no joke thing, I have money in the bank, but I want to continue doing my little hustling and selling. Amen?
Amen.
Not knowing that the Lord is telling me to stop. And I continue, my God Almighty. And one day, my God Almighty, while I was there, I came in, my God, 4 o'clock that morning. It was a Sunday morning. And I know that I'm supposed to go to church, because I started to visit this little church up the road. People of God, when I get up, when I'm ready to get up, my God Almighty, I could not move. Come on, talk to me. Off of my side, quickly. Off of my side, my right side, from my ears, go all the way down into my waist, cripple. I cannot move my hands. My hands is like it's stuck, and it was like pain. The pain was like a river coming over. Come on, talk to me. And I start to cry out to God. I said, God, what is this? People of God, that very day I went back to sleep. And when I went back to sleep, the Lord showed me 3 people. And he take my very eyes in the realm of the spirit and take me around the yard next door to me and said, these are the people that witchcraft and obey. I have never seen these people before. He said to me, they try trick and trade at you before. But my God, but this is the time I'm showing you it now. And people of God, I cry like a baby, and it was the neighbor that have to even come over and put on my clothes, because I could not do anything. I held myself with my left hand to bathe myself and do as much as I could. Could not take a good shower. But when I'm to put on my clothes for my aunts to go in my clothes, I have to call the neighbor and ask her to help me put on my clothes to go to church. When I go to church, my God Almighty, I cry out, cry out, cry out. People of God, the people them that were there, they pray, their prayer was empty. Come on, talk. Talk to me, talk to me.
Amen, yes.
The prayer was weak, nothing was going on. Because they did not understand that I was spiritually attacked. They didn't want to hear that when I tell them that is dream. What they're saying to me, oh, it's cold, you're catching your hand. Come on, talk to me.
My God.
And I'll never forget people.
Amen.
I went, my God Almighty, home. And one night I lay in my bed and I cry, I cry, I cry, because this pain don't allow me to sleep. It has me topsy-turvy, ups and down. Sleepless night.
Yes.
I pray, I cry to God, I call to him, I said, God, God, if you don't heal me, I will not be able to lift my hands to give you a wave offering. I will not be able, Lord Jesus Christ, to lift up the Bible with my hands. Because one hand cannot clap. I will not able to clap, Lord. And because your word said in Psalm 47, oh, clap your hands, all ye people, and shout unto the Lord with triumph. Come on, talk to me. And people are going to start to talk to God. I start to talk to him. And in the midst of me talking to God, I remember even calling the pastor was disturbed. And I was told, people of God, that I cannot call the pastor those hours of night. I have to battle it out with me and the Holy Spirit of God. But in the midst of everything, my God Almighty, the Lord God Almighty come in and he deliver me. They were laughing at me in the church when I told them that God is going to deliver me. I'm going to be delivered and set free from it. And what is going to happen, name it and whatever. When I told them about the dream, they did not believe me, because they are some hard believing Thomas. They used to, and they don't believe that witchcraft and other can reach somebody, because it has never come near their dwelling. And people of God, the Lord God Almighty deliver me home. I stay home from church. and I get delivered. And when I went back to church, they said, Sister Sharon, you're okay? I said, yes, God, I prayed to God and he delivered me. And they was amazed because they want to believe that his doctor I went to, not knowing that his doctor Jesus come in and heal me and set me free from the captivity of the agony that I was feeling in my body. And people of God, arise up to tell you, my God Almighty, I've been through so much, people of God, so much, my God Almighty, not knowing, my God Almighty, that the Lord warned me dear, my God Almighty, for himself. And when it was time, my remember was there one day, and I was, my God Almighty, into that same house. The man, my God Almighty, that come to me, he took 1 month rent, 1 month security. I lived into that house for 1 month straight without paying 1 cent more. Come on, talk to me. I was there, my God Almighty, one day, and I see the light man come. People of God, knowing that I wasn't paying rent, I was there one day, and what do you think happened? I saw the oil people come to put oil into it was gas. They came, people of God, no, it was oil. They came, people of God, to put oil into the tank. And I was like, how could this be? Nobody's, this house, nobody lived. The landlord don't come around. He don't collect no money from me. But still let the oil people come put in oil in the tank. I was amazed. I was there one day, my God Almighty, and when I look, I see the house. The house carried two different parts of light. The first part I see lock off, then I look and see the other part lock off. I jump up, people of God, the light was turned off. I jump up and I go out the front. When I go around there, I saw this man with this white man with his blue eyes. I said, hi sir, how you doing? And he said, how you doing? I was calling. I said, I did not hear, I was sleeping because I was way around the back. And he said to me, this place, no light has been paid for so long. I said, sir, I don't know, because the landlord, I don't know what he's doing, and I'm just a tenant. I did not even tell him that I did not pay no rent or nothing. I just keep that because that is between me and God. Amen? Because it was the landlord that did not come and collect any rent. And people of God, believe me, everything that's supposed to be done to that house was happening. The people on the top, their light was on. The one on the other floor of three is a third tree, two-story house plus the basement. I was in the basement. And people of God, believe me, the man looked at me and he said to me, I am the person that takes care of the light on the road. And we realize that no money is paid for this place. This place is long overdue. And I said, only God knows, sir, because I don't know what I'm going to do right now. Knowing that I wasn't paying any rent, I'm saying, well, I'm not paying any rent, and I'm not paying any light, so this is it now. I said, Lord, you know it all. And because I go out there and talk to the man look at me and he said, you know what, ma'am? I have been in this thing for 30 odd years. And everybody light I turn off, they curse me. They tell me all kind of indecent word. But with you, you're so calm. You're so quiet. You're so different. You never come out and curse me. You never come out and do anything to me. You know what? I am going to go right back down in the ground. And I'm going to turn on only your light. I'm not turning on those people on top light. But I'm going to turn on the ground. And the man turned my light on, people of God. And when he turned on my light, he said to me, this is my number. If anybody come and turn it off, call me. And I will come back and turn it on. I said, Jesus Christ, you I walk away inside the house. And I started, my God Almighty, to cry. I started to say, Lord, you is something else, God. I said, God, look what you are doing to for me. You really love me, Lord, and I thank you. And I just start to talk to you, people of God. Because you all need to understand, I wasn't that strong, my God Almighty.
Amen.
And while I was here, he, my God Almighty, the Holy Spirit of God was with me, teaching me how to fast, how to pray, how to, my God Almighty, read the word, calling the word to me, teaching me. And I was there, my God Almighty, just getting stronger and stronger in him, day by day.
Amen.
One day it happened. The very somebody come there and said to me, this house belongs to me. I'm buying this house. I said, well, it don't belong to you until you buy it. He said to me, but anyway, I would like to have you for my tenant. So I want you to move your things out, and then I will call you back. The Holy Spirit said, he's lying. And people of God, I refuse to move out. The man go away. I remember them, my God, sometimes in the year 2003. Jesus.
Amen.
Somebody shout out a while ago. The year 2003, I remember, my God Almighty, the whole New York City was shut down of light. I think it reached in Canada, wherever. So I decided to leave the house and go to a friend, somebody down the road, the church that I was going to. And when I was there, the Holy Spirit waited upon that and said, somebody went inside your apartment. And I said to the youngness, I have to go back up and see what is going on, because I feel in my spirit as if somebody going to the apartment. She said, oh, it's just your mind telling you. I said, no, I hear from God. She look at me, because these things become strange to her, because you have many people of God in the body of Christ. God speak to them, but they don't know the voice of God, different from the devil. Come on, talk to me. I said, there are many people, when God speak to them, they don't know the voice of God, different from the devil. Come on, talk to me.
Invalid option.
So right there, my God, it seems like everyone get very boring. It seems like what I'm saying sound very boring to people, that, my God, might everybody just quiet. What I'm talking about, people, is how God can develop, can have you to get strong in Him. He can, my God Almighty, come in the midst of you. And when you're under His command, when you meet, my God Almighty, the person that He can able, my God Almighty, to put His spirit in, and you decide for Him to lead you, He will make you strong. Come on, talk to me.
Hallelujah. Amen.
It is time for you all to be strong. It is time. It is time.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
And people of God, I'm telling you, my God Almighty, I was there and the man came. He go inside the house. I didn't know what the Holy Spirit tell me. And when I go to the door, I saw the door slightly open. I said to the youngest, I said, come and look at this. I said, I did not leave the door like this. Because what he do, he leave the door open for whatever, whether it's insect, whatever to run in, whatever to come in, and can do whatever, because he want me out. When I push the door, my God,
amen,
go in, everything for me was scattered out on the floor. Come on, talk to me. All my stuff that I used to sell it, that I park on the step, break down, mash down. I have a bottle of liquor inside here that I didn't know what to do with them, so I just put them down in the bottom of the break front. And he, my God, the neighbor went in and drink, and lay all the empty bottles in the way. So as soon as I pushed the door, all I could hear is bam, 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 everything scattering down. I said, my God, I'm going to look at this. I started to plan that I'm going to take them to court. I started, people of God, walk around in stores, taking, my God Almighty, receipt from store men. Because out on the road, they know me because of my selling. They know me, people of God. So I went there, my God, even before I started to sell, I was working into one or two of the store on Flatbush. And I went there and I asked them if they could give me receipt. I'm telling you, these store people is something else those days. Because, people of God, they were just into their Cornish thing, name it, and one of you, even though many still doing it. But anyway, people, I got in so many receipts. I got receipts from people that, my God, might buy expensive clothes, expensive jewelry, expensive this, is even furniture, this, that. And you know, funny life is, you should see my two little pieces of furniture that I have. My God Almighty, there wasn't nothing to what I was telling lie about. And people of God, I decided to take them to court. And after I get everything and I call in the police and I show the police everything and decided my God to go and pick up the police report and go to court, I hear the Lord God Almighty said, stop it, stop it, do not do it. Come on, people.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Every time.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, Lord. You see the thing about it? For us, my God Almighty, to be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. Being in obedience, you will never to put on the whole armor. Because, my God Almighty, if you want to be stuck in your ways, you will not ever to do the things that God is required of you to do. You will not.
Amen. Hallelujah.
I never forget, people of God, I decided not to take them to court. I stand in church one day and I said, God is going to fight my battle. He's the God of all redeemed, and He's going to fight my battle. You want to see people looking at me? God, they are saying, she just got saved. How is she talking like that? Not knowing the quality time that I'm spending with my Jesus. People of God,
thank you, Jesus.
In the midst, my God, in the peak of everything, the Holy Spirit of God, He was in the midst with me. And it happened that the man bought the place and he come and he said, you have to move. I said, okay. He disgraced me, people of God, on that avenue and tell everybody how nasty and how stink my place is and what I'm doing from what I'm not doing. That when the rain falls, all the men, they call them manhole, all the manhole that run under the sea, always intend to fill up of water. So the water come inside the place because I'm in the basement. And what the water did, people of God, come in and wet up stuff. So you find the stinking water from outside start to smell inside the basement. So when he come in there, he said, that is me smell like that. And he do everything. He curse me, he disgrace me, he carry me down. And all I remember is the word of God said, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say, my refuge and my strength. In you, Lord Jesus Christ, will I put my trust. I remember, my God, you said, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you are
no evil.
The rod and the staff will comfort me, God. And I, people of God, I touch me to Psalms 27. God, you is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? You is the
strength
of whom shall I be afraid? Father God, you see the wicked and the enemy come upon me to eat up my flesh. Father God, have them to stumble and fall. Father God, I'm depending on you, oh Lord.
Yes.
God Almighty, just pray the word. Talk to God.
Hallelujah.
Crying daily with tears running down my eyes. Because, people of God, I was facing an agony. I don't know how to get out of it. But I have a God that I know that He knows the way. And He will make a way when there seems to be no way. People of God, I remember, my God, when the man came back, he said, woman, you need to get out of my place, get out of this place. I said, can you give me some time to pack? And I started to pack my things in. People of God, the Lord God Almighty started to speak to me in His word and telling me that I don't need to carry bags or shoes or nothing. All I needed, my God Almighty, is to, my God Almighty, just depend on Him. But I wasn't getting the scripture. I wasn't getting the word of God. So right there, I pack. And people of God, I never forget, my God, I know of somebody very close to me that have a place, my God, with a big garage. So I decided, people of God, to ask the person if the person could help me. So people of God, I was able to take out everything out of that place and take it, my God Almighty, over there. And people of God, when, my God Almighty, the following Monday, when I go back, my God Almighty, to school with my daughter, because I happened to get a little cottage nearby where I was living, so I didn't have to move my daughter from school. When I take my daughter to school that Monday, and my God Almighty, in the midst of everything, when I, you know what happened? I hear the Lord God Almighty said, this testimony is strengthening somebody.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Somebody, people of God, I went to school with my daughter, and I, you know, the Spirit of God said, walk down on the street where you used to live. And while I was walking, then this lady came out. She's from Trinidad. And she said, Chan, I want to tell you something. Did you know that the landlord died? I said, what? She said, yes, my dear. While you was there packing and moving, we got the news that he died. I said, my God Almighty. She looked at me and she said, I don't know. I know it's not you kill him. I know the wicked things that he do to you. And I know that God revenge your enemy. I said, my God Almighty. But people of God, in the midst of me not knowing better, I could not even shout over his death. Because all I was saying, God, this man, where this man gone to? Is he in heaven? Is he gone to heaven or hell? Where he gone to? I mean, people of God, I was so caught up with the things of God that I'm still doing right now. Because the Holy Spirit of God is my leader, he's my teacher, he's my guidance, he's my protection. I'm trying my best to do the command of God. I'm doing everything, people of God, because what happened in the midst of my God Almighty me here, and the Holy Spirit, he becomes my God Almighty, my everything, teaching me, leading me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. My God Almighty. I did not find myself to rejoice. I was more unhappy because I was concerned about his soul. Even though he has done me so wrong, I did not rejoice. And you know, in the midst of everything, I went in the word of God and saw it. I see it, my God Almighty, in Proverbs. I think it's in Proverbs 23. Where we talk about, my God Almighty, if you be happy for somebody that is going through, he said, my God Almighty, what will happen? God will turn around what he's going to do for you. And he will, my God, cause the enemy to come at you. Come on, talk to me.
Amen. Yes.
So right there, my God Almighty, he was telling me not to rejoice over somebody that is going through. And right there, my God. People of God, I wasn't rejoicing, I was more unhappy, because my God Almighty, when I look and see what that man was going through, it really and truly, my God Almighty, pained my heart to know that he died and he wasn't serving the Lord Jesus Christ. Look what it says, my God Almighty. Can sister, I don't know if sister Gay, are you available?
Yes, I am.
Proverbs 24:17. Look what it said. Quick. When the Lord came into his word, I was shocked.
Proverbs 24, verse 17. Do not rejoice when your enemy falls, and do not let your heart be glad when he stumbles.
Read the next verse.
Verse 18 of Proverbs 24. Lest the Lord see it, and it displease him, and he turn away his wrath from him.
You hear that, people? God will turn away from your enemy and will cause you to remain in what you are going through. Come on, talk to me.
Amen.
Right here, my God.
Hallelujah.
I wasn't rejoicing over my enemy. I was sad because that's a soul that gone to hell. He wasn't saved.
Amen.
So right here, amen. My God, the Holy Spirit was building me up so strong. My God Almighty. And step by step as I go along, I happen, my God Almighty, to go into the same church that the Lord lead me to. My God, not knowing that these people have a big house and somebody's there is going to put me up. I happen to get a little cut with somebody and I went to that house and with my little daughter, she meet hell, my God Almighty, with the people, children. With those people that were being My daughter meet El, and my God Almighty, in the midst of everything, I happen people of God to get a job. And when I was on the job, not knowing my God Almighty, before I leave that job, I used to give that lady a little, because whatever I have in the bank, I used to give her a little from it. And people of God, she did not know that I have money in the bank, because I did not tell anybody. But my God Almighty happened to get a job, and I get 1 week work. Somebody asked me to come and sit in on a job, not knowing that God was telling me, don't work. But I still go on the job, and that job was paying my God Almighty $700 that week. And I stay on that job, my days. And people of God, when I, my God Almighty, get the money and ready to come back, my God, just said, okay, I'm going to give this woman at least $300 from it, and I'm going to send home some money to my children. I'm going to do this, I'm going to do to my mother, you know, to do things and so forth. People of God, I was called and said to, do not come, you cannot come back, you have to find a place in your daughter.
Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
When I hear that, I was broken. In the midst of me and that job, I went down on my knees. I started to cry. And I remember this woman that I know, that my God helped to pray me through when I just got saved the same day and started to go through hell. Meet her the same day I got saved. People of God, I called her and I told her what I was going through, and I said to her, I don't have anywhere to live. And I remember there was another lady that told me that she's going to help me get to a place that she was leaving from, but she met somebody that she believed she can give it to. These apartments were so big and nice, and were going for little and nothing, and because the lady was living in there for long, I would get it. People of God, talking about two bedroom, people of God, big living room, big dining room, big this, big that, everything in there big, for like what, $450. And my God Almighty, the lady, she was willing to let me stay there because her lease was just renewed. I'm talking about 2 years lease. And I, my God Almighty, I could have paid it because I have money, and she know I was doing the selling, but the devil come in, people of God, and switch that away. I said, okay. And right there, people of God, after my God, call the lady that I just know. And she said she will put us up for just a week. She said in a week time, try and find somewhere. While I was there, my God, my Holy Spirit started to speak to me and tell me, I'm going to give you this place. I'm going to have this lady to move away and give you this place. I look at her and I tell her, she get mad at me. How could God tell you something like that? And knowing that I'm here so long, working so hard and doing this, because she was so full of pride. She was, my God Almighty, coming at me. And people have got to need to know. But in the midst of everything, another lady called her and said, ah, I see you moving and giving the place to Sister Sharon. She was amazed. And then again come a pastor woman, called her and said, woman of God, I see you moving out and leaving the place, give Sister Sharon. And then she have to come and tell me. I said, glory be to God. And she look at me, and people, she said, my God Almighty, you are really hearing from God. And in that very day, my God, she happened to leave out. And believe the people of God, she left that place, give me. While I was there with her, I give her every cent, because my 1 week, people of God, turned out into almost a year. My God Almighty. And I tell you, I was doing so much for that woman. And it happened, my God, that's the same place. The Holy Spirit come in and start to do so much to me, people of God. Started, my God, to build me up. Started to have me praying for people more than ever. And I'm talking, people of God, just like my God Almighty, just a couple of months down the line. And people of God, I'm telling you, I stay to that place. I pray. I would call up people that I used to know. And I would say, would you like me to pray for you? And I just want to pray. It used to happen, my God Almighty. Sometimes for the day, I would pray for even 10 people. And I'm not talking about no little short prayer. People of God, I'm talking about. I would be praying. And when I don't know the word to say, I would get into the Bible. And I would pray the word for them. And people of God, things would be happening. My God Almighty. But in the midst of everything, it happened, my God, that I have money paying for the rent. And my God Almighty said, the landlord get to understand that the lady for the place leave and she gone somewhere else. And he went and tell the and we went and told it to the owner of the place. And they started, my God, to send back my rent and asking for the lady. And when I called for the lady to tell her that they want her, because she hear that I change up in the place and fix it up nice, she start to get mad because she did not let go. And that's the thing about many of us. We don't let go when God wants us to want to take us into another level. We want to hold on to stuff. When God is saying, let go from this, I have better stuff for you. My God Almighty. And right there, people, God, it happened, my God Almighty, that, my God, every time this lady called, I would have started to have diarrhea. Knowing that I'm serving the Lord Jesus Christ, but because the place is still in her name, and I have to go to court, my God Almighty, because the people keep sending back the money. I end up with three rent in my hands, my God Almighty. And I keep the money in money order because I decided that I don't want to spend it. And people of God, I went to court. I was the first person in that courthouse, my God Almighty. And when I sit there, I saw the lawyer come in, and I'm watching him because I get to understand that he's the lawyer for the place. And people of God, I saw him talking to the judge. I saw him talking to, my God Almighty, those that work with the judge. And I'm watching, my God Almighty, with one special docket, taking it from the top to the bottom. Everybody coming is letting them through. When it's lunchtime, my God, I'm still sitting there. People that come after me getting through, paying money for the place. And my God Almighty, I'm still sitting down there. And when it was time for me, my God, almost, my God, 4 o'clock, they call me. When I look around, people of God, there was nobody. And in the midst of everything, what you think they do with me, people of God, they told me that, my God, I must get out of that place because they are going to, my God Almighty, I must leave that place. But I come to understand that God Almighty was Jesus. I come to understand that God Almighty was doing something to me because the rent and everything was too heavy for me to pay, my God.
Amen.
So what he was doing, he was getting somewhere else ready for me. And people of God, while I was there, the judge said to me, he's giving me 1 hour to go and take out what I have to take out there. And my God Almighty, told me, I cannot move it.
Jesus.
I cannot take anything, only my personal belonging. And people of God, I went in and I asked the landlord for the key, and I did not even have nowhere to put anything. So I asked the super if he can help me to take the things them out. And he said yes. And the super helped me to move the things them downstairs. And he put them in the basement, not knowing that the super was helping himself. Super go through everything and he take out. So
God Almighty, Jesus.
And I'm telling the people of God, it happened, my God Almighty, that I eventually, my God Almighty, have to move away from there. But when, my God Almighty, the officer and, my God Almighty, those people that come to evict me out of that place come, I rise up to tell you, all I want to do, I ask the lady if she's saved. I ask the man if he knows Jesus. And they said they go to church and they were going around the corner. I said, my God Almighty, I start to talk to them about Jesus. I start to tell them about the Lord. Then the woman looked at me and she said to me, you can't go down this place and you can't do this and you can't do that. Not knowing that I don't really understand and know what she's talking. But people of God, I said to her, she said to me, miss, don't forget your medication. I said, what medication? She said, well, if you're sick and have medication, take it. I said, let me tell you something. One thing I'm sick of and is sin. And the medication that I take is the Holy Spirit, the blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Look at me, my God Almighty.
Jesus, hallelujah.
What kind of woman is this? Knowing that I'm getting evicted, my God Almighty, out of the place, and I have nowhere to turn. And my God, in the midst of everything, I take out what I have to take out. I leave, my God Almighty, out of that place. I went over to the neighbor. The neighbor looked at me and said, you see, I told you to work. I told you that you have a job. I said, listen, I did not come to ask of anything. All I need for you to do for me, can I stay for the night? People of God, the neighbor went, this is a woman that is calling upon Jesus. God said she's speaking in tongues. Said she do this, said she do that. She called up her church. children them. While I was there in Africa a second, I saw her biggest daughter came and called me and said to me, listen, I don't want my mother to die because I don't want to lose my mother. And she's very, very nervous knowing that you come to stay over here. There's no place for you. You don't know you're going to do it. Your daughter probably could stay into my father's chair, but she don't want nobody into this big chair because she never sleep in there yet. She never this in there yet. She never that. I said, don't worry yourself. I called up somebody that I know. The person said, let me call you back. And that person don't call me back until today. And people of God, this is me and my daughter walking up the road. And out of the blue, I hear the Lord call her name and said, my God Almighty, go to your friend Mackie. I said, Mackie, but Mackie's not safe. I wanted Mackie's going to have me to come to her house, knowing that I'm a Christian and so forth. He said, go to Mackie. I went over by Mackie, I knock on Mackie's door. Mackie looked down, she showed the key, give me. She said, open the door and come in. And I come inside and I sit with Mackie and I start to tell her what happened. And she said, well, I can help you out, but you know, I'm not here all the time. And da da da. And then right there, Mackie started to use, you know, say things to me. And people of God, in the midst of anything, I have to leave from Mackie so quick. My God Almighty, I have nowhere to turn. Leave from Mackie. My daughter was able to stay by yard up the road where she have friends with them. And people of God have to be walking on the street of nowhere to turn. I walk until the Lord tell me, take it over by the hospital, go over there. In the morning, find Chrissy and ask Chrissy to put you off. I, my God Almighty, go by the hospital, sitting down with the nice people that smell good. He said, get up from out of the company of the nice people and go and sit down in the crowd of the homeless, those that don't have in the house, those that take crack, name it, and one of you. I went over there. People of God, over there was so stink, but in the midst of everything, he made my stomach so strong, and I was able, my God Almighty, to minister to them. After, my God Almighty, in the midst of the morning, then come the security guard for the hospital, looking at me and everybody. Oh, you guys think I don't take note of you all? Come here, each eye kid, looking around and think that you can outsmart me. You all need to get the step out of here. Get out. You all are bomb. I was end up into that, calling that name, and I just take it quietly. I did not say anything, people of God, because right there the Lord was doing what? Humbling me. Come on, talk to me. God.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
People.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
I said, may God bless you. And listen to me. I said, may God bless you and thank you for not running me out last night. But now that I can see my way in the morning, God will lead me somewhere. God bless you, ma'am. She said, okay, go ahead. And I leave, people of God. I start to walk on the road. I said, God, should I go to the club that I used to stop by when I used to sell? Should I go to this place? Should I go to that place? He sent me to a sister. I go by the sister. The sister almost have heart attack when she hear me call her door. And she open up and let me in. When I tell her what happened to me, knowing that it's somebody that always eating my food, always coming to me, asking me for stuff. When I tell her, my God, that I get evicted. As a Christian, somebody that's speaking in tongues. That's the thing about it, people of God. There are many that is serving God, but they don't understand that God will allow things to happen in their life to make you strong. So right here she's saying, I told you to work. I said, my sister is my money. I show her, people of God. I show her money in my pocket. I even go as far as showing her my bank book because she don't understand that I was loaded with money. And my God Almighty, I was paying my bill. But right there, people of God, when before she see that, she wanted me out of the house. But when she see it, she start to friend me up and talking about, oh, you know, my brother is coming out from prison and I have to take him here. But you know, I see what can happen. And I said to her, don't worry yourself. The Lord don't want me to stay here. He said to me, I must go by somebody. And in the midst of everything, we end up, my God Almighty, that very day at the same meeting. She saw me and she was very frightened and saying, oh, comes, you are here before me, not knowing that the people that God sent me to a vehicle, and we did not take the bus or the train. We drive straight there. My God Almighty. And people of God,
amen.
I rise up to tell you, when I get there, where I was sitting was in such a comfortable spot. She came very late, and I was the one who squeezed her in and put her right there beside
me.
And she was so ashamed to know the way she talked to me, to know the way she deal with me. And in the midst of everything after the meeting, we say goodbye to each other and go our separate way. My God Almighty, while I was there, I tell the people of God, the woman, my God Almighty, that God sent me to stay with, rich woman, she go through my stuff them, she take out what she want, she take out the best things them, she went for my daughter stuff them was missing, my God Almighty. Anyway, people of God, one day she called me, she said to me, you cannot stay here, you have to leave, because when I was there comes a friend of her, and because the friend of her was living certain lifestyle, and I told it to her, she went and tell the friend, and the friend was very wroth, she was very mad, and she told her, get rid of her out of the place, don't say that she don't live anywhere. But at the same time, the friend seems to be a millionaire like herself. So what happened? She listened to the friend and she run me out. People of God, before she run me out, the Lord sent me down to a church. He said, go to the man of God. God, I said, find your place to live. And I said, man of God, the Lord sent me to you and said that you must find me a place. The man said, huh? He was shocked like Scooby-Doo. He said, huh? When he said, huh? I said, yes, God sent me to you. He said, you must find me a place. This is what he said to me. Okay, come back to me Monday morning and I will talk to you. He give me the address and tell me where to go. When I go there, I saw him come out to me. And people of God, he take me around the back and he showed me the place. He said, this is a place, one of the most beautiful basement I have ever seen, people of God. And he said to me, this place is going for $1,000. I said, oh, not me, I can't afford that. I said, God tell me to tell you how much I can afford. And he was there, my God Almighty. I said, I cannot afford more than $300 to $400. And he said to me, what? I said, that's what God tell me. This man, this is a pastor, he's a bishop. And he said to me, okay, I'll take $400. And people of God are living to that place until the enemy start to use this man of God up against me. Because when I go into the church and declare and decree and open up my mouth and say, thus saith the Lord God Almighty, everybody start to come up against me. So right there, I have to leave from that church. And in the midst of everything, he run me out and say, I have to leave. And people of God, I went, my God Almighty, the Lord, the very same night I was there, I got a phone call. My God Almighty, it was my son, my God Almighty, child's mother, that called me and said, she's sick and tired of living by herself. And what about us getting a place together? I said, Lord Jesus Christ, look at you. Look at you, God. Look what you are doing for me and my child. And people of God,
amen.
I'm telling you.
Amen. Amen.
I even said to the Lord, Lord, are you the one that is telling me to go and live with this woman? If it's you telling me to go and live with this woman, let me go and look place and close every door on me. I go out there looking for place. My God, hardly have any money. Will you believe me, people of God? Every door I go to close on me. Then I have to answer to that call, the request that my son, child's mother, my grandson mother tell me about. And I live there, and I hear the Holy Spirit said to me, in 7 months, you're going to leave New York City to Georgia. I said, yes, Lord. I start to tell people that I'm leaving New York City in 7 months. Everybody laughing at me, wondering, you leaving New York City, where you're going to get money? Or you think it's easy to go to Georgia? You think it's easy to just go there and just like that? I said, God will provide. Because what they don't know, I'm on under my God Almighty, the command of the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm under His command.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
I'm under His command.
Amen.
And everything He tell me, my God Almighty, I decided to follow. I decided that I'm not going to do anything without the Spirit of God talking to my spirit.
Hallelujah. Jesus. Amen.
My God Almighty. To that place where my grandson, my God Almighty, mother was living. She just got pregnant at the time. And my God Almighty, she looked at me and my daughter. She said to us, the only thing my God Almighty she want me to do is to help her clean and to cook. That's it. She said, my God Almighty, I don't want you to pay no people of God. When she got that place was going for $1,900 a month. And we were living up on, because she chose to live into the best neighborhood she can. And I mean, that building was the building for the rich and the famous. But because my God Almighty, she's a nurse and she's making money and all that, she decided to live there. And I'm telling the people of God, I didn't have to pay no rent. I didn't have to pay no phone bill. She even take out phone for me to use at the house, because she says she know me praying for people. So she take out her phone for me to use. People of God, she buy detergent, she buy everything and give to us. God bless her soul. And I'm telling the people of God, this is no joke thing. In the space of 7 months, my God Almighty, Sister Babette is proof to everything. In the space of 7 months, I remember my God making a phone call to Georgia. And when I talk, my God Almighty, I happened to talk to someone that I know very close, a sister of mine. And she said to me, my God Almighty, that I must check with such and such a people. And I happened to check with such and such a person. And I got the number from somebody. And the person that gave me the number, I call this other person, and I get to understand. I said, God, if you're really and truly moving me out from New York City, get me the truck, get me the place to stay, do this for me, do that for me. And I started to talk to God. People of God, in space of the same month, I was packed, move out into an 18-wheeler truck for little and nothing, come all the way to Georgia. My God Almighty, but I rise up to tell you, when I come to Georgia, that's when the fire turn up. Come on, talk to me.
Amen.
That's when the fire turn up.
Thank you, Jesus.
I met with people.
Amen.
That know me.
Amen.
I met with people, my God Almighty, that know me, and people that know me, my God Almighty, and know that I am I'm a warrior for God. I pray with them, I pray them through, things happen for them, they introduce me to other people, I pray for those, they get through, all things happen to them, in the midst of everything, things still going on with me. When I came down here, and I prayed, my God Almighty, to get a cut from somebody, in the midst of everything, going, my God Almighty, around this person, being with this person into the church, people of God, the Lord would have me to speak stuff, and because I was there speaking stuff, my God Almighty, the enemy rise up against me, and I was told that I have to leave. In a quick and a second, I was thrown out of that house, didn't have anywhere to turn. My God Almighty, have my daughter to send to school. My daughter was to stay back in Jamaica, because I did not have a place for her to stay, because she take a trip down there, she could travel that time, and she take a trip down there and came up back. People of God, when she come up back, I happened to get a place from this woman that called herself Christian and said she's a teacher. She turned against me. Everything I do, she was coming up against me in that house. When I cook, she's a problem. I put food in the fridge, she give me a part in the fridge. I put my stuff in the fridge, she's a problem. She say I have too much fish, I have too much this, I have too much that. People of God, knowing the way I live, the Lord don't want me to be on the road more than so, because he have me top down for himself. I only could pray for people. I only could, my God Almighty, hallelujah, do what he want me to do. So I was under his command, even though I was praying for people. I have to be in the school of the Holy Spirit with him, be in his presence, where he can do great and mighty things in my life, build me up for me to stay strong. People of God, in the midst of everything, I paid this woman, my God Almighty, $300 for a room. She decided that she's going to give me my old bathroom and a room. When I take a stock, she has everything in the bathroom for herself. She said, I must only take my soap and my rag in when I'm going, and my toothbrush. I said, okay. And my God Almighty, she have her children, them using the bathroom, doing everything, and I have to be cleaning after them. And she herself used the bathroom, knowing that she have one for herself. But because she want to take me for a helper, I'm talking about in the space of 3 days. People of God, I was to run out of that place, because she rise up against me so strongly and want to come down on me and tell me that I have to leave. And she said, you have to leave, but I'm not giving you back any money, because you use light, you use water, you use everything. Talking about three $500 for three days. And people of God, she decided not to give me back that money. And I was to my God Almighty cry out to God. And this lady that I know, I call her. And the call that I call this lady, she called somebody. And the person she called tell me that I can come. And I get a ride and go to the lady. When I go by the lady, my God, she said she have this little room that she can't give me this basement. When I look, no window, no nothing. I said, I'm going to be stifling here. And then at the same time, she have her animals, them and everybody live in the basement. And she said, that's where I have to stay. And I have to pay her. I said, ma'am, I cannot live like this. I cannot do it. Do you have another room? And she said, yes, her daughter is moving out of her room if I can wait. I said, no problem. She take me up into the daughter room. And in the midst of everything and me being there, all kind of things happened to them. Witchcraft and obia reached them. And it was me the Lord used to deliver them out of whatever they were going through right there. And people of God, it happened, my God Almighty, that this woman happened, my God Almighty, to meet someone. And because she wanted to go and live with this man, she said, I cannot. She said, she's not going to have me to come with her, but my daughter can come. I said, how could she be so mad? She don't know that my daughter is my skin, and wherever I go, my daughter have to be with me.
Amen.
And people of God, it happened, my God Almighty, that this woman started to move out. I didn't have nowhere to go. God have me to be going to a little church to visit. And the girl I go to the church, there was this lady. This lady told me, my God Almighty, that I can come and live with her. I went there and lived with the lady. In the space, my God Almighty, of 6 weeks, I have to run again. The house go, my God Almighty, into foreclosure. I have to run. I said, Lord Jesus Christ, what is this? People of God, I happen to know a man from the very church. He told me that I can come and live with him and his wife over by a far place. I used to call that place behind God, because these people, they don't want God, they don't want Jesus, they don't want nothing more than rum, ganja, smoking, drinking. Everybody get, my God Almighty, eyes. Everybody drunk. All these people want to do. And when you take a stock in the midst of everything, these people, my God Almighty, they want to go to church. And even the pastor himself drink. That's how it is over there. And people of God, when I went into the woman's house before I moved over, my God, the lady happened to go to court one day, and they lock her up. They lock up this woman. It was me that have to look at her and tell her through the Spirit of God. I said, the Lord is saying you need to get in touch with your family, because she has family that can help her. But because of her pride and because she hit rock bottom, she don't want her family to know that things is bad with her. And it is me the Lord used with while she was in there and help her to get out. And when she get out, she turn against me. Our friendship just go down like nothing. But I understand while I was with why I went there. It's for the Lord to use me. And I rise up to tell the people of God, when God have you to become strong, you will step into fire, and the fire will feel as if, my God Almighty, you just get a little itch on your foot bottom. Come on, talk to me. And that was because he has me to be getting so strong. I leave from there, my God. I happen, my God Almighty, to go to a sister, my God Almighty, place. While I go to that sister place, the sister, my God Almighty, have me, my God Almighty, working me like crazy. Then look at me and tell me that I have to go and work, because she cannot leave me with me like that. And people of God, knowing that I was there, everybody else I go into, I give them nothing less than $200, people of God, to sleep on their floor. Come on, talk to me. And people of God, believe me, in the midst of everything, my God, the woman looked at me and she said, because I'm keeping you here, I have to have you to leave. Because the people them that you used to stay with before, they said if you don't leave, they're going to take the position from me in the church. And people of God, I was to my God Almighty dear, and the woman tell me that I have to leave. I happen to leave, my God Almighty. The leave I leave from there, she throw me out just like that with my containers. I walk down the road and I start to sing, where do I go from here? Help me, Jesus Christ. Give me strength that I may stand with abiding place and a peace of mind. I was walking, people of God, going down the road. I've nowhere to turn. I've nowhere to live. With tears coming down my eyes. And I saw this other lady. I went over and I said to her, ma'am, can I put my stuff here? She said, okay. And by sitting down there waiting on somebody, the person, my God Almighty, don't want to answer their phone. I have nowhere to turn. The lady said she's going to give me a couple days. And she will help me to see if I can get a place. While I was there, my God Almighty, trying to get a place, my God Almighty, I was going through. But you need to understand, people, in the midst of everything, I didn't stop praying. With all the moving up and down, with all the going here and going there, while nowhere to turn, my God Almighty, happened to have a little cellular phone. My God Almighty, I would be calling people calling me. I would be praying. Miracles, signs and wonder, healing, everything taking place. And in the midst of everything, I come to understand what the word of God said. He said, my God Almighty, when he was walking with his disciple, Jesus said, foxes have holes, my God, birds have nests, but the man of God have nowhere to lay his head. I said, God, wherever you're going to put me, I will be there. It doesn't matter, God, if you want me to stay on the street side, I will be on the street side, God, but don't take your Holy Spirit from me. Let me continue to pray for people, God. Let me continue to do the work of God. I love you, Lord, and I don't want to stop, because I enjoy what I'm doing. And people of God, it happened, my God, that the woman started to show me bad face. And in the peak of everything, because she hear me praying, she's saying, how can you be praying for people while you're going through stuff? Don't you know that you need to get a place? I said, yes, I call, and I'm supposed to go and meet with somebody, but I'm waiting on a drive. The drive come and I go and I get the place. And people of God, I'm telling you, it happened, my God, one after the other. I was moving, my God Almighty, as if I have no, my God Almighty, abiding city. And people of God, knowing that I was doing that, I did not give up on God. I was, my God Almighty, just having the zeal, just as how I have it, to be on this empowerment line, to pray for people. It doesn't matter what somebody do, my God Almighty, to me. I'm always praying for them. People can act up and do what they want to do, but I never stop praying. I keep practicing myself to have love in my heart. I practice myself to have peace in my heart. I practice myself to my God Almighty, not to my God Almighty. I want nobody. I just practice myself, people of God, to do the right thing. Because, people of God, if I keep my God Almighty people up, I know that the Spirit of God will leave me. So right there, you need to get it in your spirit. I never stop, my God. I go here, I go there. Everywhere I go, people throw me out of their house. But still yet, walking, my God Almighty, with tears running down my eyes, singing to God, crying to God, saying, my God, I will not give up. You see what the Lord put in my spirit? There was a time, my God, before I come to Georgia, in New York City, I rise up to tell the people of God, I get to a place where I did not have any money, but in the midst of me, my God, that was the place before they evict me. Get this in your spirit, people of God. I did not have any money. One day I was so, my God Almighty, feeling for something to eat. I wanted, my God Almighty, to eat, my God Almighty, at the simple thing, salt mackerel. I feel for salt mackerel, and I feel, my God Almighty, for, you know, just provision like dumpling, banana, yam, name it, and so forth. I did not have no money, and I went before God. I said, God, I'm feeling for so and so and so. And I said, God, I'm depending on you. And in the midst of everything, somebody come knocking at my door. And when the person come knocking at my door, the person said to me, here is some money. And when I look, people of God, it was enough to buy me food for me and my daughter for the week.
Thank you, Jesus.
And I tell the people of God, different from that, my God Almighty, I get to a stage where I did not even have the very thing that called panty. I did not have panty, people of God. All my panty them start to get old hold on me, because I give away all my money, and before I could able to buy new stuff, I did not. And I remember people of God, I used to have to sit down and take needle and thread and soap every panty where they are tearing, the elastic stretching out. I can't, my God Almighty, able. When I go out on the road, sometimes I have a bump in my side. I have to even tying up some rubber shatayamakunde. I have to be even tying up some of them. But I rise up to tell the people of God, when I happen to be in the midst of people, I feel so happy. I wasn't paying that any mind. I wasn't looking, my God Almighty, on what I was wearing and what I did not have. I was just, my God Almighty, being obedient to the Spirit of the Lord Jesus Christ. And you need to get and understand, people of God, my God Almighty, right through, going daily, doing what God wants me to do. I did not give up, and I wait on the Lord, and I do without, and I did not have. And my God Almighty, when it come on, my God Almighty, to monthly, knowing that, my God Almighty, I was there, and my daughter, my God Almighty, hallelujah, was there with the people of God. I have to tell my daughter, when she pass in McDonald's, pick up enough napkin. When I go and buy Antoil was, my God Almighty, for me to use as Antoil. Those are the things I was using. I even, my God Almighty, have to get material, people of God. And I'm talking in the year 2000, knowing that I was coming from a life where I was singing, making money. My God Almighty, you need to get this in your spirit, people of God. In the midst of me, my God, come down, because God wanted to take me down to build me up. And he wanted me to taste, to be strong. He wanted to humble me. I was to be obedient, my God Almighty, going through and living, my God Almighty, as if I don't have nobody. He tell me not to call mother. He tell me not to call no family members. My sister Merlin was in Boston. My sister Denise, my God Almighty, she was in somewhere in America there working. And you know, God bless her, sometimes she, every now and then, she used to send me a little money, and I used to be so blessed to have it, people of God. But God shut me mouth. He said to me, tell nobody what you're going through, because whenever God is doing something in your life and you tell it to somebody that don't really understand, they will want to mess up the process of what God is doing. Yes. And you will not be able to get the glory. That is the reason why he teach me to stand still. He teach me to stay quiet. And even so, in the midst of me living, my God Almighty, even here, don't care what I'm going through, I don't really utter it, my God Almighty, much, because I don't want nobody to mess up the process of what God is doing. And people of God, I'm telling you, I suffer, knowing that I was having thousands of dollars. God Almighty stripped me of everything. He allowed people to steal from me. He allowed people to beg me, ask me, take from me. And I give. But all I see he did for me, while I was in New York City, somebody called me from my barn land, went to my mother and said, I have a piece of land I want to sell to your daughter. At that time, I was throwing a little partner. And people of God, I throw that partner, my God Almighty. And I able to buy that land for 3,000 US, 1 acre of land. And today, that land is back home, sitting down, waiting on me. And people of God, that's the only thing God have me to show out of all the sale that I was selling. Because in the midst of me selling, I was stealing. I used to go to the wholesale place, and those, my God Almighty, that are cashier, they would just take money from me, and I would just pack up the people goods, and I would just take it to wherever. And when wherever I take it, people would be stealing from me. So right there, I could not even utter a word, because my God Almighty, I get to understand that there's a saying that said, thief from thief, God laugh. Which I don't know, God laugh about those things, but that was pleasing in his sight. So people of God, I'm telling you, so much things, my God Almighty, that I was going through. People of God, after I give up on everything, give away everything, do everything to please God, be under subjection of the Holy Spirit of God, and decided, my God Almighty, that I'm not going to, my God Almighty, look to the right nor to the left. People of God, so much things, my God, there comes a time I was so homeless that better of what I had was to go underneath my God Almighty basement, unfinished basement. I remember I was under a basement one night, me and my child, and when I lay down, dear my God, roach from all both crawling over me and my daughter. One of the time I feel something even tickling on my lips, and when I put my hands there, the roach run as if he want to run into my nose. As I'm people of God, when I wake up and look over my daughter, so many teenagers, because the heat under the basement of the roach to rise. And people of God, I was just laying there, and I was killing roach and boxing off roach, and trying not to wake my daughter too much, because I did not want her to shout out and make any noise. People of God, you need to understand, I've been through so much, but in the midst of me going through, I still praying for people. I did not give up. I did not have a time where I want to say, no, I'm not going to pray. Even so, in the midst of me going through, my God, might having a toothache, people call me, I pray them through, and the pain, my God Almighty, was up on me, barely leave me. I pray for somebody, God touch them, heal them, dry up the blood. My God, there was a woman that was having a heavy bleeding. My God Almighty, she called me one night. She said to me, Sister Sharon, I'm in pain, I'm in agony, I need some prayer help me. And people of God, I cry out to God, and I pray for that woman, and in the midst of everything, God dry up that woman's blood, and she was, my God, healed, like the woman with the issue of blood. And as soon as I finished praying for that woman, you need to understand, people of God, the pain of agony started to reach me. I was crying out as if I'm a mad person, and a little boy looked at me and he said, Sister Sharon, how comes you praying for so many people? How comes God using you to heal so many people, but still yet you, God don't want to heal you? I said, I don't know. God know what he's doing. And people of God, I would be crying, I would be shouting, and my God, I forget about, my God, being shame or standing up with any pride, because I know that I'm serving the Lord Jesus Christ. It did not stop me, people of God, from praying for nobody. But in the midst of everything, God want to bless me, my God Almighty. And that's why he allowed me to have that toothache. But next time I'll talk about that part. But I rise up to say, people of God, I've been through so much. People treat me bad. People, my God Almighty, throw my clothes out in the street. People throw oil on my clothes, messed up every piece of, oh God Almighty, messed up my clothes. People do me this, people do me that. People of God, I was moving. It's like I have no, my God, abiding city. And people of God, you need to get this in your spirit. Of all these things I was going through, I did not stop praying, I did not stop reading the word, I was doing prayer and fasting. I tried to stand fast in the Lord. I tried to stand firm. I did not, my God Almighty, look to the right nor to the left. I go to nobody, my God, unless God send me. I sit down, my God Almighty, my sorrow and my pain, and I rock like a mother that don't have anything to cook for their children, and all I do is just utter. People of God, I get to a place where I could not cry. I just start to And while I'm doing that, I'm telling you, the tears just coming down. And my God, I will be hiding from people crying. I don't want nobody to see me crying. Because if they see me crying, I get to understand, my God Almighty, that they're going to come in and mess up the process between me and God. And God keep telling me, Mom is the word. Keep hush, say nothing to nobody. Trust me.
Amen.
That's all he's keep telling me. Trust me, trust me, trust me. And people of God, I go through and I go through and I go through. And I never give up. Never give up. One day, my God Almighty, I was before the Lord. And I decided, my God Almighty, to check out. My God Almighty, how many times I move. And I remember counting 40-something time, and the Holy Spirit said, you might think it's 42 times you move, it's not that. But people of God, I'm telling you, I go through so much, so much, so much. Get in this place. Oh God, I end up in the worst. Come on, talk to me.
Amen.
To get this place, I end up in the worst. I was to my God Almighty find myself on the floor of a drunken man. Somebody that drink like crazy. Somebody that happened to
invalid
almost lost his mind. When I want to pray, I have to pad myself, come out in the cold. Walk the cold place and pray. Because people of God, that's something that I don't want nobody. I don't know what I would do if I stop praying. I need you all to get that.
Amen.
I don't know what I would do if I stop praying and reading the word. Doing the fasting, doing the prayer. God Almighty, in the midst of everything, He tell me to relax. He tell me to stop eating meat. He tell me to stop doing everything, people of God. He take away my appetite from every little thing and only give me appetite for a few things. Even today, my God Almighty, I do not crave for nothing. I am not even the type of person to get up and say, I feel for this and I feel for that. I only eat accordingly because I have no appetite for food. Because the way He has me. I need you all to get that and understand that. Because He said, I must be under His command. Come on, people.
Amen.
I must be under His command. And all these going through that I go through, people of God, He taught me how to read. He built me up, my God Almighty, in prayer and fasting. He made me, my God Almighty, so strong in Him. That's my God Almighty. Today, I'm at a place. I find myself, my God Almighty, as the flesh, my God Almighty, is here, and I'm not mortality. I rise up to tell the people of God that there are times when I, my God Almighty, can be dealing with people. And I will say, Lord, I'm sick and tired of this behavior. I'm tired of this. I'm sick and tired of that. But one thing I have to give God thanks for, I cannot hate people. I cannot despise people. I cannot turn away from not praying for people. I cannot, people of God, if I have a situation dealing for somebody, don't care what that person done to me, I still praying. I will not stop praying. I cannot turn away and say I'm not going to pray, because I come to understand the way the Lord has me, the way He built me, the way He formed me, people of God, different from my time when I was born. Out of my mother's womb, you need to understand, in the spiritual realm, the way He has me, people of God, I am not myself anymore. I needed to get this and understand, I am not myself anymore. He let me know that I don't own myself anymore. He said, you belong to me. He looked at me in New York City and He said to me, whatever happened to your life, I must get the glory. I remember one day a woman looked at me and she said to me that she's happy to know that God is using her to be a part of what He's doing in my life. And after she said it, I went to God and I said, God, are You using this woman in my life? Because you see, people of God, I want to be, my God Almighty, so close to Him, and I don't want to be attached to nobody, so that when God wants to send me and want to use me, I have to be asking somebody. And I hear the voice of God said to me, nobody will get the glory from your life but I, the Lord Jesus Christ. I am the one that bring you out. I am the one that is doing in my life. And everything I do for You, it is for my glory. Even God as far as said to me, whatever you are to gain in life, you must suffer for it, people of God. I'm telling you, to whatever I have to get, I have to be suffering, suffering, suffering. But my God Almighty, in the midst of me suffering, I rise up to tell the people of God that my Lord Jesus Christ, what He did, He, my God Almighty, made me strong. He asked me not to pay nothing, any mind. I don't focus on situation. I don't focus on problem. I don't focus on trial, because the word of God says, said, what can separate me from the love of God? No perseverance, no trials, no tribulation, no nothing, people of God. Every time Satan commits something, I said, you commit something again. Know that the Lord God Almighty is with me, and you is not my friend. So when you rise up against me, the word of God said in Isaiah 59:19, when the enemy rise upon me like a flood, the Spirit of God will lift up a standard. So people of God, I come to tell you that my God Almighty, in the midst of everything, you need to get it in your spirit. Don't care what I'm going through, the Spirit of God will rise up for me, my God Almighty, and I know he will do it for you. I am just telling my testimony to strengthen somebody, because you need to get this in your spirit. When you open up your mouth and say to God, God, I want to work for you, know that whatever you ask God for, it is coming with some trials and some tribulation. And if you don't pass your test, you know right there, God will not able to pour out into you. So you have to pass your test. So people of God, I rise up to tell you that my God Almighty, I see where God want to do for some of you. But my God Almighty, you have to not let the enemy have stronghold over you. The word of God said you must rebuke the devil and let him flee. Because I rise up to tell you that the enemy, he will want to block, he will want to stop, he will want to do things to you. And if you don't be careful, my God Almighty, you will swallow the enemy pill. And for you not to swallow that pill, you have to be obedient. You have to ask the Lord daily, say, God Almighty, when you wake up in the morning, help me, Lord, to focus. And when you focus, you said, God, help me to get conscious. Because you need to understand, many people, when they are sleeping, they will wake up on their mind after life spin around the world and come back to them. But I rise up to tell you, when you're under the commandment of the Lord Jesus Christ, he said in his word in Psalms 119 and 165, he said, great peace will I give to you, my God, if you keep my commandment, and nothing will offend you. And right there, people of God, if God did not give me peace, I would lost my mind already. I don't know where would I be, my God Almighty. That is the reason why you need to get and understand, when I think of the goodness of the Lord Jesus Christ and all that he has done for me, taking me to the valley of the shadow of death, my God Almighty telling me not to fear no evil, for he's with me. People of God, arise up to tell you that's the same thing God want to do for you. You might not able to go through the many things that Sister Sharon been through, but I rise up to tell you, my God Almighty, that you're going through. You have to have patience. You have to, my God Almighty, let God train you and get you in a place where you can humble you, because God used a woman of God to humble me. This woman of God, when she meet me, she start to treat me so nasty. She would tell me how much I'm not any educated. I cannot read, I cannot write, but still it, I want to tell her things. I want to correct her, which that is not true. All I did, when she speaks something, the Holy Ghost would utter in my spirit and tell me to tell her what she said. That's not how it is. This is how it is, or that is how it is. But because she has so much pride, she don't believe that somebody like me can open up my mouth and talk about the things of the Lord Jesus Christ. But when she get to a place in her life, she look at me one day and she said, my God, you surprise me. You're like a sponge. You're just sapping up, sapping up, sapping up everything that God gives to you. You're just sapping up, sapping up, sapping up. And one day she look at me and she said, you know what I realize? Everything that you are doing now, I used to do it. I used to pray. I used to hear from God. I used to hear the voice of God. I used to this, I used to that. Why am I not doing it now? Something is wrong. What have you done to me? I said, how can I done something to you? When the Lord God Almighty it is in the midst, and you see me daily and hourly, my God, just praying, fasting, staying before him, my God Almighty. People of God, I tell you, this woman would treat me so bad.
My God.
So bad.
Jesus.
Every time, my God Almighty, when she opened up her mouth and speak to me, all I do, my God, I just go into the little closet. I said, Jesus. I said, Jesus. I'm waiting down here by the river. Will you come, Lord Jesus? Satan don't want me to cross. Satan don't want me to cross. But I'm waiting down here by the river. Will you come, Lord Jesus? If you don't come to my rescue, God Almighty, I'll be lost. I get to a place in my life when I was getting so overwhelmed. I said, God, if you don't do something, I'm going back out there to the man them. I am going back out there to the man them. I'm going to have my relationship them. It doesn't matter what wants to happen to me, God. You need to deliver me. I cannot take it anymore. And shortly after saying that to God, God, move her out of my way. That is how I was delivered from her. But I rise up to tell the people of God, I might skip up and go fast with what I'm telling you, but what you all need to get in your spirit, I left my barn land, my God Almighty, and I came, my God Almighty, to this country. And from the day I step into this country, it's like, my God Almighty, Maka start to juke me. I want you all to understand that. If you get what I'm talking about, all kind of Maka people of God, all kind of stuff sticks biting me. When I'm talking that, people of God, I mean, my God, stuff that I'm going through. People of God, I've been through hell, hell, hell. I go through hell, 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 hell. I never know, my God Almighty, that hell was going to over. And many people might see me now on this empowerment line, preaching, teaching, crying out and praying, but nobody know the hell I'm going through. But that is between me and my God.
Amen.
Because he told me he will never leave me nor forsake me. And that's the thing about many of us. When we, my God Almighty, can't keep us, that is all, my God Almighty. People of God, I realize that when, my God Almighty, you get into too much conversation of talking, the enemy will have you to get away, to start grumbling and complaining. Come on, talk to me. Talk to me! That is how, my God Almighty, that spirit take me. But I thank God for Jesus, because he has delivered me and set me free from that captivity. My God Almighty. Because, people of God, I was even finding myself getting into gossiping. The prayer that I have prayed on YouTube, I don't know if many of you see it, but as where it said, the Holy Spirit of the Holy Ghost exposed Sister Sharon. Come on, talk to me.
Conference continuation.
That's a prayer where the Holy Ghost, my God Almighty, exposed me. They exposed my God Almighty, that he exposed me. That is what my God Almighty caused me.
Conference continuation on.
That is what caused me, people of God, to be delivered from gossiping that was coming my way. Many people don't seem to understand me. When I'm in a conversation and when I'm there talking, the Holy Spirit have a way to tell me, drop it, stop it, stop it, get out of it. But when I speak and open up my mouth many times, people can get offended because they don't understand the God that I have in the midst of me for so long and the way he has taught me. So right, dear people of God, I am not myself anymore, and that's what God wants to do with many. He wants to train you up in his own way. Don't care how educated you are, you cannot enter into his presence with education over him. He wants you to come humble, because what he deals with, all he deals with is wisdom. wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. That's what he did. Amen. It. It's not about the education, it's about being empowered. It's not against education, my God Almighty. It is okay because he's the one that created it, but he don't want us to come off up and puff up to him with it. He wants us to come as little children. He wants us to, my God Almighty, be like a little child so that he can help us to make it right. And that's, my God Almighty, how we're able to become strong. Knowing, my God Almighty, that I was in the house of the man that almost, that was crazy. The other day I was passing there and he moved. They take him into a home, it look as if. Because his house is empty. No curtain at the window, it's just empty there. Maybe they're ready to rent it. That was the house that helped me. When a man of God, somebody that call himself an elder, into the church that I was going, I begged my God Almighty to help me out to live there. Wanted to pimp me, to use me to pay his bill, even backup bill that he have. He wanted me to pay. And when I told him what I can do, he did not want for me to do that. One day I was there, people of God, with the fridge, my God Almighty, having stuff for myself, and him having only one or two things in it. The light turned off. And then, my God, when the light turn off, I have to be the one to go there, people of God. Just moving 1 week, and I was to pay, my God, I think it's about $600 for light bill. That's how we want to live. We want to pimp whoever can come in the midst of him. And when I told him, my God, I don't have, and I tried to give him something, because right there, if you pay something, they will turn the light back on. So what happened? I gave him some money, and he went and paid, not knowing that he did not have any, but he went and paid. And people of God, he used to look at me, have a fan there blowing at the door. Whenever you pass there as a woman, the fan would want to lift your clothes up. So I always, my God Almighty, try to wear pants and try to wear tights under my clothes. One day I was passing and the breeze blow me, and he was like, wow, you know, I will look, I'm sorry, I will look. And this is somebody that, my God Almighty, they have been preaching on the pulpit, preaching like a madman on the pulpit. And in the house where I'm living, my God Almighty, he's building up this lustful spirit with me, not knowing that I'm a woman of God. He know it, people of God, because he hear me praying every day. He hear the way, see the way I live. Name it on one of you. Sometimes in the very church where we go, the woman of God would have me to be speaking, does say the Lord, name it on one of you. And people of God, my God Almighty, it happened that I have decided, my God, to take a trip down this side, to my God Almighty, go to a church conference. And when I, my God Almighty, happened to go to the church anniversary, when my God Almighty, I was here one night at the man house, the same little white man house, I got a phone call, and he said to me, if you don't reach this place by this evening, I'm gonna throw your things out, I'm gonna throw your stuff out. I said to him, I have no control over that. I said, I have no control over that. I said, whatever your heart pleases to do, you can do it. I said, I trust God, and I put everything in the hands of God, not knowing that God is leading me to this place. And people of God, it happened, my God Almighty, he threw my stuff out the 17th of October 2010. And when he threw my stuff out that day, early in the morning, my stuff would stay there, would stay outside all the day until, my God, I think it's about almost 2 days, my stuff out in the yard. And people of God,
option.
I did not have no way out, and there comes somebody from the church decided to help me. I didn't know where I was going to put my stuff. But when the Lord God Almighty sent me again to another man of God and tell me to ask, and when he tell me to ask the man of God to get to, if I'm to help with a place, not knowing, my God Almighty, that right where I'm passing, going to the church, the house is sitting at the corner. But because the yard was so full of bush and garbage, The house was covered with trees and bushes and all them stuff. And people of God, I'm telling you, went over there to the man, and the man said to me, he's going to contact somebody. And when I was there going to church, to and fro, they wanted me to join the church. I tell them I cannot join the church because I get so afraid of people. I reached the stage, people of God. You see, I'm not going to get into it, but what I want to say to you all, it happened, my God, my true limits of me moving up and down. I could not even settle into a church because every church I go into. And when the Spirit of God move upon me, and when I happen to do what God want me to do, not out of order, not out of control, because I know the principle of God. I know that He work in decency and in order.
Yes.
But when
Amen.
I get the chance to Amen. Do so, I would do it. And people of God, when men and women of God see the power of God upon my life, they come up against me and they will have me to leave their church. When I give testimony about the opening of blind eyes that God will use me to do in the midst of me moving up and down and have nowhere to stay. When I would give testimony about people crippled and God healed them. When I would give all kind of testimony, they did not like it. People church that I go into and give this testimony, they come up against me. One day, a man of God was at the pulpit, and this is what he was saying, talking about God using you and have nowhere to live. That is what he said over the mic, throwing word at me. That his wife have to look at him and bow her hand and said, no, don't say that. And people of God, I happen to leave out of that place. And my God Almighty, when I go to the man of God, and the man of God consult my God Almighty, the landlord for this place, I was, my God Almighty, at the man's house, sleeping on the floor. People of God, let me say this to you all. The cream carpet was B-L-A-C-K, black. And people of God, when I tell you about stink.
Yep.
And all I have was a piece of tin carpet to put on the ground and sleep on that stinkness.
Jesus.
My daughter, my God Almighty, and was to sleep into the recliner, and the recliner that she sleep in, people of God, it was so stink, and I have to take a sheet and throw over it, and my daughter sleep on it.
Jesus.
You need to understand, people of God. And when I got the news call that I was thrown out in the yard, I said, God, I'm not concerned about anything. You have to take care of everything if you want me to get anything from what He threw out.
Amen.
And people of God,
Amen.
I remember one night I was at the church and I happened, the Spirit of God came on me. And I asked the wife to sing a song in the midst of me being homeless. And I stand there and I started to sing the song. And when I started to sing the song, my God Almighty, the song I was singing was, as I stood in the night with my head bowed low, in the darkness as black as could be, and I cry to the Lord and I said, oh Lord, don't ever hide your face from me. Like a queen, I would live in a palace so tall, with great riches to call my home. But right now, on this earth, I don't. Oh. don't hide thy face from me. Kind of forget this song, but it said, hold my hand all the way, every hour, every day, from here to this great unknown. I wasn't thinking, my God Almighty, of where to go. All I was asking God to take my hand and let me stand where no man stand alone, because I was feeling, people of God, so lonesome. I felt as if I was all alone in this world for the many, many going through that I have to be going through. And lying right at that moment, I did not know where I was going to end up. And people of God, that night at that church, the pastor know my situation, his wife know my situation, other people, one or two people that was trying to help me find place, know my situation. There was a woman of God, when she, my God Almighty, take me to one or two place, and I said to her, the Lord show me the house that I'm going to be in. She said, I cannot pick and choose at this moment. She take me to a place, and when I go to a place, a lady wants for me to work for her. And the lady told me she cannot pay me no money more than to give me a place to stay, but I must work. She only can give me, I think she said she can only pay me either $150, but I have to give her $600 for the month to pay rent where she gonna put me. And I said to her, how must I work for you for 5 days? Now, people of God, what do I need to get this? Jesus. So what happened right there, people of God? The woman wanted for me to work for her for $150, and then I must pay her $600 for the month. And she said, people of God, she said to me that the job is night and day. I have this, and she only can put me into the settee to stay. And my God Almighty, me and my daughter must stay into, I must try stay into the bigger city, and my daughter must stay into the small one. She said that's where she can give me to stay. And I have to work enough money to pay our rent and security, so that before I can get the place that she's going to rent to me. And people of God, I speak to the Lord. The Lord said, no, no, no. The Lord said, remember, I told you not to work. Because what you all need to understand, from the day I started in New York City, 2013, I went to get job, and I got the job, but the Lord blocked it and said, don't work for nobody, you're going to work for me. You're going to work for me. He said to me, you're going to work for me, and you must not work for nobody. And people of God, I wasn't working for nobody. If God don't provide for me, I don't have it. But I was just, my God Almighty, take it step by step. Until today, if God don't provide for me, I don't, my God Almighty, go out and beg. Go out and do anything. It's only since God bless my daughter with a little job. But in the midst of everything, little is much when God is in it. And I'm just going
through. That's right, amen. God Almighty. Amen.
When I rise up to say, people of God, when my God Almighty, I left from there, the woman of God, she take me here, she take me there. And she tried to, my God Almighty, give me place to stay. And because she tried to give me place to live, people of God, she was getting so frustrated. She said to me, you know what? You have to take place, whether it is furnished or not. It doesn't matter how much they are charging. I will make up your money. I said, that's not what God tell me. That's not what God tell me. That's not what God show me. And I was speaking to her very nicely, very softly, very humbly. But because my God Almighty, she don't understand me. And I did not even happen to tell her any of my testimony. So all she believe is just she alone go through this, go through that. And what I come to understand, when some people go through just a little marital problem, they think that they have the whole world upon them, not knowing my God Almighty, that this woman of God been through so much, people of God. So when I speak my God and say one or two things, or when they see my life, they want to compare my life to them, and they want to get jealous, they want to get bad mind, and they want to treat me as if I'm nobody. But guess what, people of God, I never, my God Almighty, open up my mouth and trace anybody. I always bless them, because the Lord God Almighty told me in Matthew 5, he said, my God Almighty, for those that despitefully use you, my God Almighty, pray for them, bless them, my God Almighty, don't, my God Almighty, curse them, just bless them, don't care what they are doing to you, just take, just stand strong, because when you suffer for the Lord Jesus Christ, he will, my God Almighty, reward you for everything. And people of God, I just humble myself, and the woman of God looked at me and she said, one day she said to me, I'm tired of doing this. And I'm not going to do it anymore. You're on your own. I said, I'm not on my own. I said, the Lord will lead me in the path of righteousness, right, for his name's sake. I said, God will lead me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. She looked at me and she draw back. And she said, like, as if she said, wow, you is something else. I never see nobody like you. And people of God, she wanted to give me any way, but because I don't take it, she back out. And in the midst, my God Almighty, of her backing out, because I need to understand, sometimes some people don't belong in your business with you and God. Sometimes it is just you and God that must work it out. Sometimes, my God Almighty, when God is working on things and a person that don't cannot see and discern what God is saying and doing, they will come and mess up the process. So this is for you and I, my God, to get and understand that when God is doing something, it best sometimes you keep your mouth shut and go through it.
Amen.
Come on, people. Because if you involve some people in what God, they will mess up the process, my God Almighty. So what happened right there, people of God? The very same church I went to, my God Almighty, the man of God went to the landlord and he talked to the man, and my God Almighty, he in a quick and a second, I got a phone call, because he took my number and he told the man to call me. And when he called the people of God, he said to me, my God Almighty, that he want, my God, the landlord look at me and he said to me, I must pay him so and so for it. I said, you're mad. I said, you're mad. You're getting crazy. That's what I look at him and say. He laughed and he said, you know, easy. You serious with what you just said? I said, yes, because it's impossible for what you're asking me for, because it don't worth it. And he said to me, what you mean it don't worth it? I said, it do not worth it. Because people of God, I don't need to explain what I'm talking about. That is between me and God right at this moment. I said to him, so and so and so and so and so. And he said, okay. He said, how much? And I tell him. And when I tell him, he shake his head and said, you is something else. I said, take it or I'll leave it. But all I know, I said to him, when he opened the door and I come inside, I say, God, I thank you for this place. I bless this place, God. This is a house of prayer. This is where prayer is going to go up, God. This is where your name is going to be glorified. Before I even talk to the man about the price, come on, talk to me. And I start to walk around. I start to walk around. And when I get my God Almighty back to him, he said to me, I never knew he was going to come back. I say, I have to be blessed in the place because it belonged to me. And he looked at me and he laughed. And when I look at him and tell him, people of God, I said, this is what I have and I do, and this is what I can afford. Is it okay? And he looked at me and he said, okay, all right. I said, glory be to God. And people of God, if somebody, my God Almighty, happened to come my way and take me, my God Almighty, up by the place where my things was thrown out in the yard. When I go up there, people of God, all my stuff them scatter out. It's only the mercy of God caused the crackheads, caused those people that walk the road and roam the place did not come in and take anything. Because what you all need to understand, there's always angel watching over me. Come on, talk.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
I rise up to tell you, nobody could touch anything for me. Not one piece of stuff. But in the midst of me searching through stuff, there was stuff that was missing. And the Holy Spirit said to me, is the brother take it, the minister take it. He's the one who took me. And I said, that's all right. And people of God, I did not do nothing. And the gentleman that take me up there, he bring me down, my God. I think he make about 4 trips with me. And he carry everything. And I happen, people of God, to come here where this have this big storehouse. So it was even easier for me to put everything in the storehouse and just take from there and fix out the house. So it was easy for me to move in and to fix out neatly and nicely and everything. When my God Almighty, the woman of God that's supposed to help me get the place, when she hear that I got the place and how much I'm paying, she was amazed. Believe me, the Holy Spirit said to me, she's ashamed because she wants to force things on you. And when I told her that the house is such a color, when I tell her how the house look, when I tell her about everything, people of God, after that, after the Lord showed me the house, the Lord give my sister Merlin the same, my God, the same house. Show to Sister Merlin exactly how the house is. Sister Merlin tell me the same thing. I said, yes, I believe in my sister because I get the same vision of the house. And people of God, I did not get a dream. Sister Merlin get a dream, but I get a vision. The Lord show it to me just like that. And people of God, when I got the place, the same little white house, the same step going up, the yard with the trees, everything, not knowing that I was passing the house daily going to the church. People of God, that is how I come here. And I said to God, God, let me not be homeless on my birthday, God. Because people of God, you need to understand, the Lord God Almighty was so gracious and compassionate. He bring me into this house one day before my birthday. And my God Almighty, then he start to speak to me and tell me about God's midday glory empowerment line. That's how I end up under this roof. Because y'all need to get, when I laid on my God in prayer and fasting, and God start to bring to my memory how many times I move, when I check it out, people of God, from the year 2009, from 96 until 2010, I have moved, my God. This house make 56 houses I have lived into.
Mighty God, Jesus, have mercy, Lord.
56. And what you all need to understand, listen to this. 5 is the grace of God that is upon my life that caused me to sit. And 6 is my number. Come on, talk to me. Because 56 times. And you need to understand, people of God, I just, my God Almighty, come in here. And I come to this place, and people of God, I am settled because there was a curse that a man of God placed on my life. And this curse that they placed on my life, that's what caused me to come to America. And this is not only, one day I'm going to tell about my God Almighty, the move up and down back home. That was a moving up and down as well. When you check it out, I probably move about 100 times from I was, my God Almighty, a young girl till I becomes a big woman.
My God.
I give the Lord Jesus Christ praise and glory. I give him honor. So people of God, because I did not stop, I let no trials and tribulations separate me from the love of God. I keep praying. Come on, talk to me. I said I keep praying.
Amen.
I never stop praying. I never stop seeking the face of God. I never stop, my God Almighty, praying for people. And I'm not talking about just praying for Sister Sharon and praying for God to empower me. I never remember praying and asking God, said, God, I need power. Father God, give me power. No! All I did, my God Almighty, was praying for people. And that's how God developed me and helped me to stand on the word of God. So today, people of God, that is how I come to be a warrior in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ through the trials and the tribulation that I have been through, my God Almighty. And I rise up to tell you that one day there is a powerful testimony coming up, people of God, for the trials and tribulations Hallelujah, Jesus. No, nothing. Every plan that Satan plan, the Spirit of the Lord, the Almighty, bring it down. So I give you, Lord Jesus Christ, praise and glory. And I rise up to tell you, for whatever you all are going through, stay focused. Stay conscious.
Amen.
Get connected so that Jesus Christ can inject. Get out of whatever you're in. Stop letting the devil having some of you to be sleeping. And don't want to get up and pray in the morning. Don't want to, my God Almighty, pray whenever the Spirit of God is telling you to pray and to read your Bible and to do whatever, my God Almighty. Some of us, my God Almighty, some people, they are easy. Well, my God Almighty, it's easy to take up an ordinary book and read it, but to read the book of God, to be read the word of God, it's a heavy burden. It's easy, my God Almighty, for somebody to go on their phone and play games and do this and do that, but it is hard, my God Almighty, to stay in the presence of God with the phone, with the Bible. Some people, my God Almighty, it is hard for them to pray, but to spend time on the phone talking and talking, all is well. Some people, for them to stay before in the presence of God, no, but it's okay for them to jump into their car, go here, go there, and roaming all over, and don't want to, my God, spend that quality time. But today, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I come against that. I cramp and paralyze that from off your life. I bring down the power that Satan have, that stronghold that he have upon your life. I cramp and paralyze it. That is the reason why God would not have a blind to lead a blind, because people of God, you don't hear nothing yet. If I was to talk about witchcraft and obia, that's the next story to tell, and I'm not going to speak about that. But I rise up to tell you, people of God, God has made me strong through the trials and the tribulation, through the moving up and down, calling upon his name. He turned up the fire, but still yet he's the one who come in and told me into my God Almighty, Psalms 8:1-10. He said, open up your mouth and I will fill it with words. And that's how I come to utter and cry out to the Father for somebody, not for myself. That is the reason why many can't understand why Sister Sharon on the empowerment line not praying for herself but praying for someone else. People, you need to understand, I don't need my God Almighty to pray for myself, because the Lord God Almighty got my back. The Spirit of God is with me. The power of God is in me. And because of my name's command, I don't need to worry. So people of God, I rise up to tell you, God has made me strong. Give him praise and glory.
Hallelujah, Jesus. We give you all the praises, Lord. We give you all the glory. We worship you. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory be to your name, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Father, Lord, you are awesome, God. You are an awesome God. I thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you.
Your word.
You are worthy. You are worthy, Lord. You are a miracle working God, Jesus. I thank you. I thank you. I thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You are a real God, Jesus. A real God.
God. Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I glorify my honor, I thank him.
King, you are Lord.
Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. He is the King of Kings, Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord Jesus.
Praise trust and obey. There is no other way than to be happy in Jesus. When you trust and obey, in spite of what you're going through, there will be peace in the valley.
Thank you, Jesus.
And that's what he has given unto me. All through my trials, I gain peace. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord, for your peace.
All through my going through, I gain peace. And that's what carry me. Peace sail me through everything. And I bless the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. It is peace that sail me through. Peace, peace, peace.
Jesus. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
So rise up together, people of God. If you trust and obey, God will take you through all the way.
Amen.
He will. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Is there any testimony? Anybody have any testimony? I'm saying
yes,
testimony.
I do.
Not just to talk something that is not yet complete. If you're going to talk a testimony, testimony must be something that you've been through complete.
Okay.
You don't have a completion. If you have not complete what you're going through, it is still going through the test.
Amen.
Right.
It's still going through the test. Whenever you've been through something, you can't and you overcome it, where you have your arm weeping in the night and joy in the morning, you can talk about it. Amen.
Amen.
Glory be to God.
Amen.
Invalid option.
I bless God to be strong, y'all. I bless him to be strong. Stand strong and in the power of his might. Hallelujah. When you can't able to put on the old armor, you know that you're living it, you're in it. You don't take it off the bed to do nothing. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. To just know that God will bring you through as well.
Thanks.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Oh, God. Glory be to God. Hallelujah.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah.
Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
Never happened to write the book. If God want to have me to bring it out in movie by having somebody to bring it out in movie, it will happen. Because I know many will be watching.
Yes. Oh, yeah.
Amen.
This is not off. This is not off of what I've been through. This is just a little part. Glory be to God. He bring me out. He bring me out. That is the reason why I don't care what, the hell what I'm going through. I can help you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Glory be to God.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Sister Sharon's testimony and what she was going through. Saints of God, I've been there.
I will come for you to speak. Allow the Holy Spirit to do what you have to do in your life.
It's Jesus.
Just allow the Holy Spirit to do what you have to do in your life. Because all I was sitting down here is just sitting down and viewing what God wants me to do next. We don't murmur anymore. We don't grumble anymore. We don't complain. We don't worry. We don't fret. We don't I mean, things is so unbearable that we can't even do what we have to do where God is concerned.
Amen. Amen.
So that's what this message is
Hallelujah.
About, to help somebody to be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. And to put on
Amen.
That whole armor that you can able to stand against the wiles of the devil. When you get to a place where water can fall on you and just roll off, then you know you overcome the plan of the enemy. Amen?
Amen.
Glory be to God. Let us do the testimony. Not testimony. The benediction in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Jesus.
The benediction.
Rest with me and abide with us all.
Now and forevermore.
Now and forevermore.
For the goodness and mercy shall follow us.
Surely goodness and mercy shall follow us.
Our children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren.
Our children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren.
Family, relatives, and close friends. And we shall dwell in the house of the Lord.
And I shall dwell in the house of the Lord.
And on godly day, your empowerment line.
And God may take glory and power line.
All the days of our life. To bless him, to praise him. To honor him, to love him, to bless each other, and to respect each other.
To esteem each other more than ourselves. To pray for each other.
And to give to each other what is due unto each other. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah.
Amen. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. We bless his holy name. We praise his holy name. We glorify him, we honor him, and we thank him for his goodness and his mercy, for his loving kindness. And as I said, people of God, I am praying for God to make you stronger. Amen.
Amen.
I'm praying and I'm hoping and looking to see you all get stronger in everything that you are doing. God can able to take you through. But don't forget, prayer and fasting will take you to the other level in Him. Reading His word and spending quality time with Him. Hallelujah. May the Lord Jesus Christ bless you. May His face continue to shine upon each and every one of you. Your family, children, relatives, close friends, neighbor, and stranger. Don't forget, people of God, tell somebody about the empowerment line. We're not going to be online tonight, but we'll be online next week, Friday night, by the grace of God. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. And don't forget, we have prayer from Monday to Friday, even though I will let you all know, because I believe I'm getting ready to go before the Lord. So I'm not sure if I'm going to have services coming Monday. But when I come on the line Sunday, you all will know what is going to happen after. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Glory be to God. So you all be blessed. Be blessed. Tell somebody about YouTube. Go on YouTube. And whenever you go on YouTube, put in your comments. Tell your testimony on the line. And let the Lord's name be glorified. Speak to somebody about YouTube. Let people read. Let people read and hear about what is going on and God's midday glory. Go and view it. God bless you all. In Jesus' name.
Yeah.
And by the grace of God. God bless you all. God bless you all. By the grace of God, I will try my best to put out, hallelujah, the three messages about being stronger in the Lord. And in the power of His might.
Amen.
God bless you all. Love you, love you, love you. Love you all.